Welcome, welcome. It is Monday, 9 a.m. I am the Sports Jock, Wayne Gandy. You're listening to the Sports Jock Show. I am happy today, not just because I'm here to greet you on your Monday morning, but something special happened about 100 miles southwest of the Grady Curve here in Atlanta, Georgia. Something special happened down in a little town called Auburn, Alabama. And just so you won't make the mistake of thinking that maybe your computer froze, you're going to hear this multiple times today. I might play it every half hour. It's going to be like a news break. Just in case you missed it. This happened Saturday night.
Fourth and 18.
Same defense, though. Three-man rush.
Let's it go. Oh, my God! Oh, my goodness!
Hey! The state of Georgia just had a bad week last week. I mean, it got bad. It started off with the Braves moving to another county and the mayor taking the podium talking about, oh, yeah, we just going to build some mid-class apartments. You weren't even in the loop, Kasim Reed. Stop lying. It was three people that knew that the Braves were leaving. Then this happened to the Georgia Bulldogs. And then in the next hour, we're going to talk about the Falcons. We're going to make the Falcons real quick. We're not even going to harp on them long. Maybe I'll just say it now, and then we won't even talk about them. Big Kenny's prediction of the Church Lady and Mount Vernon and Friendship Missionary Baptist, I drove by them the other night. It was kind of eerie because I did feel like maybe the curse is real. I don't believe in voodoo. I did play in New Orleans. I didn't see any people walking around the graves as they claim, but how the Falcons look on the field, maybe they are cursed. Losing to the Bucks. And in a couple of days, the Saints will come marching in. It's going to get real bad real soon. But we'll talk about that. We're going to talk about LeBron James Jr. We just have a great show. Charles Barkley and him, he's going to keep using the N-word, he says. We got a 400-pound running back in high school. Yes, I said a 400-pound running back in high school. And people scoring 100 points in games in 29 minutes. I had to make sure I wasn't drunk last night. But we are here. This is the Sports Jock Show. I'm the Sports Jock, Wayne Gandy. The funny man himself, Big Kenny, is in the building.
Good morning. War Eagle.
That's what I'm talking about, Big Kenny. That's what I'm talking about. Come on over to the other side, man.
Luke, you are an Auburn fan.
Come on over.
You know what it reminded me of? You could probably remember when Doug Flutie threw that pass.
Mm-hmm.
And was it the What game was that?
They were playing the Hurricanes, if I can remember.
The Hurricanes. Yes. What game was it? It was some bowl game.
It probably, back then, it probably was the Orange Bowl.
The Orange Bowl or something like that.
Yes.
Last minute, what they call Hail Mary pass.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody thought it. Everybody just thought it was, you know, might as well try for the sake of trying.
Right.
And they won the game. And when I saw this, I thought, this is one of those iconic, phenomenal, forever will be remembered backbreakers.
Right.
I'm talking about because Georgia got back in the game.
Folklore is what part they put in.
Folklore, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. That's right up there with Tonto.
Paul Bunyan.
Paul Bunyan and Babe the Blue Ox.
Right.
John Henry, it's right up there. Fantastic game.
And I had the pleasure of being in the building. I was on the plains of Auburn. Great game. We're going to talk about that later in the show. But we have a farewell to say today. Frosted Tips has married Rich. He found him a rich old lady and slayed her. And now he will be moving to Dallas and, I guess, milking cows and stuff in the state of Texas, right next to George Bush. Good morning to you, Guy Rawlings. We can no longer call him Frosted Tips now. He's back to Guy Rawlings.
From Oklahoma City.
From Oklahoma. It's Omaha, Nebraska.
Omaha, Nebraska. Okay.
Tips is retiring, man. You know, going back to TV, the little sports anchoring and reporting out at CBS in Dallas. Looking forward to it.
So you can get an up close and personal of Tony Can't Win a Game, Romo.
You know, I'm trying to get on. What's the show with the show on, what is that, ABC, where they
the Ewing? Job, J.R. Ewing?
No, Job Ideas with
Shark Tank.
Yes, I'm trying to get on Shark Tank.
I don't know what that is. What is Shark Tank?
It's like you have a business
idea. Do I need to put that on my bucket list?
Put it on your list.
With Netflix
put it
and
on your
McFlurries.
List.
I got to put...
You know, had I known that before this morning that Guy was leaving, we would have reenacted that scene from New Jack City where Nino came in and stabbed Christopher Williams in the hand. Just for leaving, never like you know me. Pretty young brother.
Well, congratulations, man, and hopefully maybe you can call us one day from the big city of Dallas, Texas. Women, watch out.
Be our correspondent out that way.
Watch out. He's going to get his third family started down in Dallas.
Look, right now the other two families are like, hey, what's going on?
As you know, here in Atlanta, the Braves moved out to Cobb County. That was the dominating story of last week in this city, along with Atlanta will begin a new area code. So there's no more 404. There's no more 678. There's no more 770, the new area code. So if somebody calls you, just so y'all can write it down, is 470. Just thought out of this. You know, I like to give public announcements.
What you thought
people.
Out is just 770 and 404? That would never
so
go
I guess
in that
Luda
rhyme.
Got it. Luda,
right,
Luda
got
to put
throw, right.
470.
What you thought I was just 678 and 470? Oh, no. Nah,
the Braves have left. They're going about 12 miles up the road to Cobb County, get everything they want. Mixed living, condos, all kinds of things. I'm going to miss the Braves from being downtown. What about you two guys?
Me, man, how's it?
They've been there since 1967. Since they moved to Atlanta, they've been downtown. They were at Fulton County Stadium, the TED, for the last 20 years, and now they're going to probably the most congested area.
How is it Cobb County can afford that when they've been laying off teachers and stuff?
Hey, we don't care nothing about education, man. What are you talking about? Sports is first. What is he? Big Kenny, I thought he was going down to Dallas. You're going to a city that really don't care about education.
Those are some valid questions, though. But, you know, Cobb County has vowed that this will not affect the taxpayers at all. It will not. Now, I know that because I live in Cobb County just a few miles from where they're planning this stadium, that they closed several schools to open up brand new, more up-to-date, state-of-the-art educational facilities. And they say that this Braves stadium won't affect the average taxpayer at all. They're going to use special business taxes and put a couple dollars on the price of a rental car, and we won't feel the pinch at all, except for when we have to go somewhere on game day.
Right. The traffic right there in that conjunction, right. 75, 285.
And the construction will, I'm sure, undoubtedly snarl things. So, you know, we'll have a couple of years to get used to the gridlock.
Yeah, it's 2017, and they said they might run MARTA out there for you that don't know. That's our public transportation here in Atlanta. So,
but don't you think that the team is really just kind of holding the city by the shorties and just trying to get a better tax deal? get Atlanta to say, okay, fine.
I think the Braves really looked at how the city of Atlanta embraced a team like the Falcons, who, in their mind, does not hold the public consciousness like they do. And basically, the Falcons got everything they want. The Braves got nothing. So we're going to take our toys and our sandbox and move up the road and let those people eat off of us. That's kind of how I see it.
And the Braves have actually won a pennant. They've actually been championship in their division many times.
The only team outside of Georgia Tech who won a national title back in 1990.
Right.
The only professional team to ever win a championship in Atlanta.
Right.
So now I guess they'd be the Cobb County Braves, maybe? No?
Mm-hmm. And then somebody yesterday told me.
I know the Cobb County Police happy. They're going to be passing out some tickets up there. They love to get some tickets in Cobb County. So
somebody told me it's racial.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
It's racial.
We got so much racial. Which kind of racial is it?
That they don't care about, you know, the African-American fan. The one that's in the stadium.
The one in the stadium every game. We're going to go to break. We come back. We're going to talk about Charles Barkley and his racialness and the Auburn Tigers as well. That and much more. 888-926-7562. And Valentino is back in the house. She almost cracked a smile. We'll be back right after this.
Hey, if you missed some of the show today, listen to the rebroadcast Fridays, 12 to 3 p.m. Eastern on CRN-FM, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Saturdays, 1 to 4 p.m. Central on Q90.5, Camden, Alabama. And 24/7 online at thesportsjoc.com.
More of the Sports Josh Show with Wayne Gandy coming up next. Your busy lifestyle demands performance. Energy drinks and shots can be an acquired taste and can cause jitters, crashes, and even stomach discomfort. The new 8-Hour Energy Patch is the natural, sugar, and calorie-free alternative to energy drinks, shots, and even coffee. It's the only energy that sticks. Just two time-release patches will keep you going at work, the gym, or even a night out. No unpleasant taste, jitters, or crashes. For a 12-hour boost, just add another patch. For only 4 hours, use one. You're in charge. Visit 8hourenergy.com for more info and your free sample. Do not exceed 3 patches per day.
Brew! 80! Wings! Ice cold brew! Hot, hot!
Ooh, that was a heck of a sack.
Chicken wings? Ice cold brews? You know, Bob, he might want to hit the showers and head to Hooters.
Hooters is your one-stop shop for food, fun, and fantasy football.
Get your very own fantasy football draft kit and keep up-to-the-minute stats with Hooters' totally free Wi-Fi.
Great food, great fun, and your very own cheerleaders, the world-famous Hooters girls.
Hooters! Visit HootersDraftParty.com to book your party.
This is a guided meditation on parenting. Take this time to breathe deeply and close your eyes. Right now, you're completely in control. Unlike the time you and your son played basketball and you attempted to slam dunk. Or when you tried removing those raccoons from the basement. Concentrate on the soothing sound of my voice. Release the memory of when you wrestled with that beehive in your son's treehouse. Let go of the time you thought that skunk was a cat, or when you pulled into the garage with your son's bike on top of the car. Deep breaths. Deep breaths.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you. For more information on how you can adopt, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt U.S. Kids, and the Ad Council.
Can you tell if these vegetables are being contaminated with bacteria that could cause paralysis? Listen, you can't see it either. Use different cutting boards so that the bacteria in raw meats and seafood and their juices doesn't touch prep surfaces for other foods like veggies. Raw food may contain bacteria that can make you very sick or worse. Roughly 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year, but you can keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov. Brought to you by the USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
Today in school, I learned a lot. In chemistry, I learned that no one likes me. In English, I learned that I'm disgusting. And in physics, I learned that I'm a loser.
Today in school, I learned that I'm ugly and useless. And in gym, I learned that I'm pathetic and a joke. In history, I learned that I'm trash.
Today in school, I learned that I have no friends.
In
In English, I learned that I make people sick. And at lunch, I learned that I sit on my own because I smell. In chemistry, I learned that no one...
In biology, I learned that I'm fat and stupid. And in math, I learned that I'm trash.
The only thing I didn't learn in school today...
The only thing I didn't learn today...
The only thing I didn't learn... is why no one ever helps.
Kids witness bullying every day. They want to help, but they don't know how. Teach them how to stop bullying and be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov. A message from the Ad Council.
Sassy! Sassy!
This week's episode, Rattlesnake at the Pond.
Oh, Johnny, skipping rocks at the pond sure is fun.
Hey, look, a moving stick.
That ain't a stick. That's a rattlesnake.
Sassy, we're in danger.
Good idea, Sassy. Go get Mr. Gunderson. You will in a second, but first you'd like to tell us something we may not know about animal shelters in the United States?
It's getting close, Sassy.
Approximately 8 million pets enter shelters each year? The majority of which are in shelters because of owner-related issues that the animals have no control over?
Sassy's a rattlesnake! Save us, Sassy!
What, Sassy? You wish you were videotaping this? Sassy!
Sassy is brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org. Remember, adopt!
And now, back to the sports jar, Wayne Gandy. Welcome back to the Sports Talk Show. I'm the Sports Talk Wayne Gandy. Massengill, is that your Death Row song? That's not your Death Row song? Oh, okay. Find me your Death Row song. The last track you ever hear before they put you to sleep. I like to see how... It's Massengill, right?
Massengill.
I keep getting it mixed up. It's Massengill. That's our DJ in the studio today, Massengill, coming to all strip clubs every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Massengill is on the ones and twos. Are they ones and twos now? Is it just a computer? I guess it's just a one, but, you know, maybe I'm wrong about that as well. But welcome back. Show that clip again. Over there texting, dude. I need the Auburn clip. Your finger needs to always keep your finger on that right there today. Play it again. I can't get enough of it. It's like Big Kenny watching Serena. He can't get enough of it. Not the War Eagle part. Oh, see, they messing up the whole
show. The ghost
show. Don't
of
worry
the bad
about
producer.
It. Yeah, we'll try it again later. The Sports Shock did go to Georgia Perimeter College on Friday. I went over there and caught a basketball game. Shame on you people that go to Georgia Perimeter College. There were 8 people in the stands, people. The lady got upset with me for even asking, where do you pay? She was like, oh, it's free. I'm like, I've never been to a free college basketball game. And she said, oh, no, it's free. I walked in. I saw why it was free. It was only 8 people in there. Y'all should go support your team.
Who did they play?
They played Beacon Prep.
Now that explains
one of One of my friends had a son that plays for Beacon Prep. He's a freshman over there. And shame on you, Beacon Prep. Do some cardio. I mean, I've never seen a team so out of shape than you. But Georgia Perimeter College does have, it was a solid basketball game. Some great dunks over there. It's off of Candler Road for you that live here in Atlanta. 20 in Candler, but make a right, go down about a mile and a half. Georgia Perimeter College is right next to the GBI building, so you are very safe.
Yeah.
Very sad. I didn't even know the GBI was over there.
I don't know how safe you are, but if something happens, they'll figure it out really fast. No, it's not far to transfer the evidence.
Before we get into the Charles Barkley and Matt Barnes controversy of last week, just send a big, big, huge shout-out to our man Jack Taylor from Grinnell College. Once again, Jack has scored 100-plus points in a college basketball game. He scored 109 points last night against Faith Baptist Bible College. I don't know why we're playing clips of North Carolina, but I guess the ghost of the bad producer is in the building. But Jack Taylor, this is the second time he's done this. Last year he scored 138 in a game. This year, only 109. He's slipping.
That's right.
That's a lot of shooting, Big Kenny. 109 points in any level of anything. Is I don't know how he's getting that many shots off, but you're talking about being hot. Guy, you got to be hot. You ever been that hot in a game?
No, I've never been that hot in life. 109, I haven't even been 109 degrees in Vegas or something. That's crazy.
That is crazy.
I mean, you know, there's not. It doesn't seem like there's time enough in a game to do that.
It doesn't. I don't know how I watched. They said he didn't even play but like 30 minutes.
Did anybody else score?
Let me find the final score.
I think it was like 173
to 173 to 129.
Yeah, that's crazy.
When he scored 138 points, that was against Faith Baptist Bible College. Yesterday he scored the 109 against Crossroads College.
Then, you know, somebody should file him for bullying.
Big Kenny, I know you got some basketball in your history. Have you ever been that hot on the court?
Yeah, I've been that hot. Of course.
I knew you were
of course. You know what I'm saying? 109 points here, 115 points there. What's the big deal? You know what I mean? I'm amazed that this dude scored 109 points by himself, and the other team still had enough time to score 123 points. That, I mean, you know, who's operating this clock? Who's operating the clock at this game? Does this dude wake up every 30 minutes and go, start it over?
He was 24 for 48 from three-point land. He was dropping it. I mean, that is some shooting. No matter what level you are, the three-point line is still the same distance. So he was shooting the ball.
Do you think his other teammates resent him? Like, man, this dude.
For being that hot?
Well, I'm saying they only scored 173 points total.
Right.
He had 109.
Yeah, basically.
So everybody else is on some, man, my mama was here tonight. She wanted to see me play.
You got to get the rebound.
Right.
Just put the rebound back. Other than that, go in the paint, I'm going to shoot, get the rebound.
He's a black hole, huh?
He is. He probably would do nothing on the next level, but he's going to have some great stories.
Division III, right?
When he's Division III, yes. In the NBA, the big story of the week was Matt Barnes, and he got into an altercation with Blake Griffin, on the court, which spilled over to him getting ejected, which, as most knuckleheads now, they go to Twitter and get themselves fined.
was he into it with Blake Griffin or defending?
He was defending Blake Griffin.
Against.
And here's the tweet he put up. I love my teammates like family, but I'm done standing up for these
ninjas.
All this.
Norwegians. All this. brouhaha.
Does me money. This is the tweet he put up. You know, as usual, after you do that, you have to come back and apologize and blah, 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 blah. But, it brought up the N-word, which has been in the news here basically since Riley Cooper. We've been heavy on the N-word. Seems like everybody is using it. Charles Barkley, when asked on the TNT broadcast, had this to say about the use of the N-words in this situation.
You want to get off your chest?
Matt Barnes, there's no apology needed. I'm a black man. I use the N-word. I'm going to continue to use the N-word with my black friends, with my white friends. They are my friends. This debate that's going on with the Miami Dolphin thing about bullying and racial slurs. Hey, Ernie, in a locker room and when I'm with my friends, we use racial slurs.
So this was appropriate to tweet this out?
No, no.
Okay, that's what?
No,
he got fined $25,000 for tweeting this out.
I understand. He should not have made it public. But this debate, it goes back to the Paula Deen thing, where they're like, well, black people use it among themselves, it's in rap records. Listen, what I do with my black friends is not up to white America to dictate to me what's appropriate and inappropriate. Matt Barnes should not have said that publicly. You are 100% correct. But
I don't think anybody right now is telling you, Charles.
No. Learn, I've been watching TV for the last few months, going back to Paula Deen, going to the incognito thing. White people, white reporters, number one, first of all, they don't have the courage to go in the locker room. That's why they're reporters. What we say in the locker room, and it should always stay in the locker room, I might add that also. But the language we use, first, sometimes it's homophobic, sometimes it's sexist, and a lot of times it's racist. We do that when we're joking with our teammates, and it's nothing personal.
Understood.
But this national debate that's going on right now makes me uncomfortable that regular people try to act like they have the courage of to play pro sports. They don't have that. And Mike Wilbon did a great job on television today. I love his show.
That is our man. My Auburn Tiger. I can say Auburn Tiger again. War Eagle! I'm all over that today. Y'all get used to it. Especially you guy. Florida Gators suck. At least Kenny has enough courage to accept that Southern Miss, like he said before the show, gave him no hope. So he's good.
Yeah, Southern Miss is not. there are no expectations there.
But Charles is addressing this. But Kenny, I've seen your comedy shows. I don't know you to use the word a lot, maybe with your friends, but in that format. In that forum, you have used the N-word. Guy, I don't know whether you've used it. I've always told you about the locker room. What he's saying is you see four white guys over at the locker. You walk over as if you're me, and it's like, so who are y'all hanging tonight? That's just it. And then we laugh like, hey, man, let's go get something to eat. That's just, I mean, okay. They might see us three hanging together with a watermelon at. That's just it. Nobody gets up and starts fighting. It's just teammates being teammates and good fun. And these are the same guys. They ride to work together. Some of them carpool. This is just, it's a freeing world where you get to knock down some of the stereotypes and you get to laugh at it a lot of times.
And why does it have to be limited to the locker room? I know that I come from an environment, period, where we pretty much, you know, we live and die by the First Amendment. In growing up, we could be having a cookout at my house and a white neighbor come by and an uncle would, hey, white boy, what's happening? Right. You know what I'm saying? And nobody got offended. It's just people can't be people anymore. This world is so politically correct now that it's sickening.
It's the corporatizing also of society. Everything is corporate, everything is going, taking you to HR. You know, they, I mean, do football teams even have an HR?
You can't tell a woman.
They probably will now, but
you can't tell a woman she looks nice in a pair of jeans without her running off to find a lawyer. You know what I mean? And file some sort of suit.
And then she's mad at her husband because he don't never say it. That's
right,
why.
Right.
That's why
right,
she
right.
want to take you. Cause
now my groping her might be grounds for a lawyer. I'm just saying, but to saying something.
We're going to go to break. When we come back, we're going to talk more about this. We got Michael Jordan playing beer pong. I never played that. I'm quite sure Mason Gill has beer pong every weekend with him. 888-926-7562, The Sports Jock. That's JOC.com.
Hey, join the show online, live, or anywhere you are on Skype. Just click Skype from the Sports Jock app or add the Sports Jock to your Skype friends list. It's the Sports JOC.com.
Hi, I'm Charles Barkley. When I need sports and entertainment, I listen to The Sports Jock with Wayne Gandy.
More of the Sports Jock Show with Wayne Gandy coming up next.
Can you tell if these vegetables are being contaminated with bacteria that could cause paralysis? Listen, you can't see it either, Use different cutting boards so that the bacteria in raw meats and seafood and their juices doesn't touch prep surfaces for other foods like veggies. Raw food may contain bacteria that can make you very sick, or worse. Roughly 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year, but you can keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov. Brought to you by the USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
In 50 feet, turn left. Why are you driving so slowly?
After a few drinks, I'm taking it slow.
Well, you're not fooling the cop behind you.
What?
Get ready to pay in 0.1 miles.
Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Me, a cat, moving in with a new human. It took a little getting used to. She has these weird games she likes to play, like this giant feather. She sticks it in my face. I swat it away. She sticks it in my face. I swat it away. It's almost like she thinks I enjoy it. But seeing how much fun she gets out of it, well, I guess it makes it all worth it. Humans.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
Here at the GED Pep Talk Center, we've got a pep talk that can motivate you.
Sometimes things don't always turn out the way you want them to.
You can improve your future.
Now get your game face on and take the first step towards a better life.
Hurry up! Don't make me repeat myself.
Whatever level of motivation you need, we've got a pep talk for you. Call 1-877-38-YOUR-GED or visit yourged.org for your pep talk and for free classes in your area. GED is a registered trademark of the American Council on Education, brought to you by Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
Hey, there's my son.
Hey, Dad.
What's wrong with your voice?
There is nothing wrong with my voice.
Well, it's just sort of...
Hello, Dad.
Susan? Guys, I think it's about time to get in the car and maybe see some green things.
What are these green things you speak of?
This weekend, unplug. Getting closer to nature can get you closer to your family. To find the forest nearest you, go to discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
That was a heck of a sack.
Chicken wings? Ice cold brews? You know, Bob, he might want to hit the showers and head to Hooters.
Hooters is your one-stop shop for food, fun, and fantasy football.
Get your very own fantasy football draft kit and keep up-to-the-minute stats with Hooters' totally free Wi-Fi.
Great food, great fun, and your very own cheerleaders, the world-famous Hooters girls.
Yay! Visit HootersDraftParty.com to book your party.
And now, back to the Sports Jock, Wayne Gantz.
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. Massengill, is this your death row song? No? Have you found it yet? No? It can be a black rap song, man. It's okay. You know more of it than me and God. Big Kenny, the only one that can equal you in knowing that stuff. Because we know the guy to your left, you know, he's over there talking about Lovely Day.
What is yours, Sports Jock?
Mine probably would be that One More Chance by Biggie, you know. I pop up. All of it, you know, that what's that? And that's the name of that track, right?
Yeah, One More Chance.
No.
The original.
The original. Yeah. We'll play that in the next break. Right. As we went to break, we were talking about Charles Barkley and the N-word. He was on the TNT broadcast addressing the Matt Barnes tweet, in which Matt Barnes used the N-word. He didn't call anybody particular the N-word. But he was fined $25,000 for that tweet. For you that don't know, Charles said that he's a black man. He uses the N-word. He's going to continue to use the N-word with his black friends and with his white friends. They are my friends in the locker room. When I'm with my friends, we use racial slurs. At the end of that, even Shaquille O'Neal chimed in and said that he uses the N-word and is something that he will continue in his small arenas of his friends. He doesn't see where everybody gets to dictate, and Big Kenny is, and I think the whole panel of us is saying we are just way too sensitive with everything. And one word, we're just making, saying one word now makes you that.
This is what I think I find, I take offense with, is we are football players, we are hunters, we are, I don't know, you know what I'm saying, we're florists, whatever it is,
right.
Whatever it is that we do, and then we have some sort of issue in the florist world, and then everybody comes out with some, I can't believe that florist said that. What does it matter to you?
Right.
What does it matter to you as a cattle farmer? What does it matter to you as an accountant? You don't have anything invested in this
mm-hmm.
particular life
right.
other than you viewing it for entertainment or you're hearing about it on social media. I think a lot of this social media has made it so popular for everybody to voice their opinion, even opinions that don't matter. Shut up. Nobody wants to hear from you, Glenda Jones in Nebraska. Who cares?
And that's my cousin, man. Hey.
So?
And the thing that I keep saying here is all these places become like family. And we all are in families where families talk to each other different than family let other people.
But that's the point.
You know,
that's the point, though. You got to keep it in the family.
He's wrong for the tweet. Yeah. I hate tweeting altogether. I don't understand what it ever did for someone that makes them better. Every tweet I see costing these guys money. J.R. Smith, $25,000 for tweeting his feelings about Brendan Jennings that plays for the Pistons. That, you know, Brendan Jennings came out with comments that J.R.'s brother is only on the Knicks because of J.R. And then J.R. is talking because we're talking to Sekou Smith at the end of the hour. I don't know when every basketball player became a triple murderer, but they all swear they got like 20 bodies in the trunk. Have any one of y'all noticed that?
Yeah, well, soft dudes always talk about that. You know what I'm saying? Because for real killers, just they let their body count speak for itself.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right.
Other people go, hey, man, you know, that's murdering Tony. You don't want
to
get on that dude's bad side. So.
But you're right. I mean, not everybody, like you said, Big Kenny, not everybody needs a mic. And that's exactly what Twitter has done. It gives everybody a mic
and an opinion.
Sometimes people say to me, you know, well, you say stuff, you tweet stuff. Why does it matter when you do it? Because people pay me to hear what I have to say. We broadcast on a sports show. I perform on stage, on television, on radio, guys on TV. People follow what we say because they want to hear our opinion.
Correct.
So when I voice my opinion, I'm not just out there randomly speaking.
Right. We're using our full names.
Yeah.
You're RO892 Rockhead. I don't know who that is.
And I'm telling you
my name is Wayne Gandy.
And you got a picture of the mascot for the Chicago Bulls as your profile picture.
Right.
So
or an egg.
So you are some totally anonymous individual
right.
that's out there talking about, you know, when I see you,
I'm gonna get at you.
It's gonna be what it is. And dude, come on now. Yeah. You know where we broadcast right. from every Monday.
Well, I want to show you an example of maybe when the N-word should have been used. I know a lot of people might not agree, but if you watch Glenn Big Baby Davis in this video right here, you might have wanted to use the N-word. Here is the forward for the Orlando Magic. That's not him. That is a car. Big Baby is at a Comfort Inn, which is very alarming that he would be at a Comfort Inn. He must have been going in there with the, here he is at the counter, he's talking to the person behind the desk. I guess he's trying to get a room at the Comfort Inn.
He is clearly lit up.
He's standing here. If you're on the Sports Talk page, you see him. We have video up. He is trying, I guess he didn't get that he got a room. I think the guy's telling me he's all booked up. He drops his head, the guy walks off. He grabs the computer board.
And then staggers out.
Hold on now. What could he have heard from this guy that makes him want to do this act? They, you know, the guy did call the police. That is the police coming in a couple of minutes later.
All he wants is an autograph.
Like, what is going on over here at the Comfort Inn? We already had the prostitute raid earlier. That's what the Comfort Inn is for, right? The roadkill?
I would imagine.
He got to be taking the roadkill. I mean, look at this here, right?
He's in Orlando.
Why
do you need roadkill when you're at home?
That's what I didn't get, yeah.
He is very, very angry. Somebody is sitting there witnessing it on the couch.
On the couch, yeah.
And you can tell that is the Comfort Inn by the floral pattern on the couch.
Now,
you ever understand why the Comfort Inn and the Motel 6, where they get that furniture from? Where is that pattern sold?
Clearance sales.
Clearance sales.
Now, I've got several questions about this. One, it's 4:03 a.m. Why are you sitting in the lobby on the couch of a Comfort Inn at 4:03 a.m.? What is going on in your life that you happen to witness this? Number two, so they don't have a room for you. You're Glenn Big Baby Davis. Buy the hotel and evict everybody.
That's what I'm thinking. Just buy a floor.
Now, I'm imagining that, couldn't you, I'm sure they've got some place reserved. I mean, you're in Orlando. Don't you have a condo for that kind of thing? You know what I'm saying? Don't you have a little spot off in the cut?
Call Tiger. Right. Tiger will let you hold a crib. You know,
because he got two
night.
Or three places like that.
Yeah, Tiger. Yeah, cold word Tiger. That's how I punch in Woods. Wood.
And this dude, now, I would imagine this is the establishment.
He has come back and apologized that he was wrong at the Comfort Inn. He should not have been in there and there causing a ruckus.
Now,
he should not have been at the Comfort Inn. Ruckus or not.
Right. And then what's upsetting is this. If you're at the Comfort Inn at 4 in the morning, chances are you're doing some stuff you don't want a whole bunch of people to know about.
Correct. Well, they know
you're
now.
You're snatching the keyboard out of the computer is not going to help with the discretion factor of this whole mission.
He was not charged, but he said he will buy a new computer for the hotel. So they must have been okay with him and didn't want to hurt their business.
I'm disappointed at the guy behind the counter who was on duty. Because if Glenn Big Baby Davis snatched the keyboard and threw it anywhere near me, I would have fallen straight to the ground, and they would have had to carry me out in an ambulance.
Oh, you'd act like it hit you?
Oh, it put my eye out. It hit a light that hit a glass that shined on a chandelier and blinded me.
Oh, man. In other basketball news, the great one, maybe some consider the greatest basketball player ever, our man, his airness, Michael Jordan, was caught playing a little beer pong. Have you ever played beer pong? This is MJ right here. Now, how does the beer pong game work, Guy? I know you've played many nights of this down at the University of Florida.
I've had my day, yes.
You throw
beer pong.
You throw the ball, the ping pong ball.
Right. And it's house rules, first of all. So it depends on whose house you're at.
Wow. It's like spades.
So, yep. So okay. You stack the cups like a triangle, as if like you
like
have,
bowling pins.
Like bowling pins. And then you try to toss the ping pong ball into the cup, which is at least maybe a third full of beer, so that your opponent has to drink whatever's in that cup.
Also, all the cups at the end are filled with some kind of alcoholic beverage.
Exactly. Right,
right. And whatever cup I throw it in, you have to go down there and drink.
Right.
And so,
beer pong don't last long.
Well, it gets a little hard. It gets a little, you know, right. It's not, because, you know.
Oh, you're saying eventually after two or three, you start missing cups altogether.
One, and two, you start, when you drink the beer, you remove that cup, so you have less cups to throw at.
So really the guy that's playing Michael Jordan is the idiot, because I'm not playing a man that has scored like 90,000 points
right? This dude's just
in a shooting game.
He's trying to get drunk for free.
When we come back from break, I'm going to tell y'all something, an interesting fact about beer pong that happened last week that I guarantee you probably missed. 888-926-7562. We also have NBA.com. Sekou Smith coming up, and after this break, we'll be right back with more of the Sports Jock Show.
More of the Sports Jock Show with Wayne Gandy coming up next.
Here at the GED Pep Talk Center, we've got a pep talk that can motivate you.
Sometimes things don't always turn out the way you want them to.
You can improve your future.
Now get your game face on and take the first step towards a better life.
Hurry up. Don't make me repeat myself.
Whatever level of motivation you need, we've got a pep talk for you. Call 1-877-38-YOUR-GED or visit yourged.org for your pep talk and for free classes in your area. GED is a registered trademark of the American Council on Education, brought to you by Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
Me, a cat, moving in with a new human. It took a little getting used to. She has these weird games she likes to play, like this giant feather. She sticks it in my face. I swat it away. She sticks it in my face. I swat it away. It's almost like she thinks I enjoy it. But seeing how much fun she gets out of it, well, I guess it makes it all worth it. Humans.
A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. Be that person. Adopt. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org.
In 50 feet, turn left. Why are you driving so slowly?
After a few drinks, I'm taking it slow.
Well, you're not fooling the cop behind you.
What?
Get ready to pay in 0.1 miles.
Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Center Court on sports, news, gossip, blah, 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 blah.
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. I'm the Sports Jock, Wayne Candy. As we left for break, we were talking about his airness, Michael Jordan, playing beer pong. Guy broke down the rules of beer pong. You put some alcohol at the end, you throw a ball, and whatever I throw the ball in, that's what you go and drink. Interesting story about this beer pong. 38-year-old Joey Poindexter was arrested over the weekend for allegedly sexually assaulting and raping at least 10 college men after he met them after beer pong tournaments. He would travel around and go to beer pong tournaments, and after some of the gentlemen had gotten drunk, he would rape them. So you might want to watch out after playing beer pong. Interesting fact. I don't make this stuff up. I'm just reporting the news. He has been arrested, and two of the guys have come forward to say that he raped them.
Jordan don't know how lucky he was to lose that game. Listen, and I'm sorry. If you're the kind of dude that likes getting it on with dudes, stop being an overachiever. Just go to a bar where dudes get down like that, meet a guy, buy him a drink, and then let it be consensual. How you just gonna come up to me like, hey, great job at the beer pong tournament, and then later I wake up confused and embarrassed like, hey, what happened? You're just
stalking,
hey, man.
Beer pong. Tournaments.
Was he an assistant coach at Penn State? Where did this guy come from?
Ba-bum-bum. But as we went to break, I told you we were going to get our man, NBA analyst, NBA.com, NBA TV. I don't know where he is right now. He's probably hanging out with J.R. Smith in New York. Our man on every scene, Mr. Sekou Smith. Good morning, Sekou.
What's up, y'all? I don't play beer pong, ping pong, no other pong. So I ain't down for no mess today.
Yeah. Oh, yo. You don't want no mess today.
I'm not playing. Yeah, tell him I'm not playing today.
Sekou, when did all these NBA players become triple murderers? They all swear they're the hardest thing ever.
Yes. Yeah, you know, really, it's embarrassing, man. It's because these guys are wealthy men making a very generous life for themselves, playing a game that anybody would cut off a limb to do to be in their shoes, and for them to take it to that level on so many occasions, you know, from Matt Barnes to J.R. Smith, man, it's really embarrassing and disappointing to see him do those sorts of things. They're not indicative of the entire league either, which is the really sad part, is that the majority of these guys are really good dudes who get thrown into that barrel with the couple of knuckleheads you see to do something they shouldn't be doing.
Are the NBA players required to have a Twitter account or a Twitter page or something like that? Do they have mandates for that?
No, I think they all want to. You know, they all want to be, you know, out there and engaged. And, you know, and the social media is hot, man. Hell, my dad is 70. He got a Twitter account, you know. and he don't know nothing about Twitter. He stay on Facebook more than anybody I know. But
he's looking up them old high school girlfriends.
Exactly. They try to get the class of 63 reunion, you know, riled up or something. But, you know, I think they all just want to be out there and engage in that mix because that's what everybody's doing. People their age, you know, are doing that same thing. So they're really indicative of a larger culture of always trying to, you know, put something out there and be provocative. And it's really unnecessary.
Speaking of J.R. Smith, the New York Knicks are not off to a hot start. Carmelo Anthony, after the loss the other night, even said it looks like we're not even trying. Something has to happen. Somebody has to go. What's going on? The New York Knicks, they spent a lot of money, got a lot of players up there, a lot of talent. What do you see happening in New York?
Well, I think first and foremost, you got to go through that locker room and find out who's legitimate, you know, who's not, who's in there to win it, you know, and who's in there for the greater good and who's in there for themselves. And once you figure that out and clear out the dead weight, I think you'll be fine. But it's hard to do when you got $49 million wrapped up in three guys, in Amari, Tyson Chandler, and Andre Bargnani, and they constitute basically the core of your front court. So outside of Carmelo, of course, I mean, it's just a lot of inner turmoil they got to work out up there. And, you know, and of course, I got Mike Woodson. Who else but Woody would be in the middle of that mess and have to sort it out and potentially be one of the fall guys, you know, if it gets to that. So I think, losing seven guys off that team from last year, and particularly Kurt Thomas and Jason Kidd and Rasheed Wallace and some of those veteran guys who would have helped keep a locker room like that in check. Now you have, you know, youngsters, Amon Shumpert, J.R., you know, those guys, Ray Felton, who's never really struck me as a real sturdy locker room leader type. You have all those guys in that locker room, and it's hard to straighten that out when you don't have quality veteran leadership in your locker room.
Now, Carmelo's contract is up at the end of the year. Do you still see him as a lock of re-signing with the Knicks?
Nothing. I don't see anybody ever being a lock after the past few years, after what we've seen with LeBron leaving Cleveland the way he did. Carmelo leaving Denver the way he did, you know, Dwight Howard leaving Orlando and L.A. the way he did. Nothing's a lot. So they're going to be suitors for Carmelo. I think the Lakers will make a push for Carmelo in free agency, and wisely so. It's going to be hard to pry him away from New York, obviously, with the extra money New York will be able to offer that these other franchises won't. But Carmelo is not the Knicks' problem. I know he's an easy target, but to me, he's not what ails the Knicks. It's the construction of the group of players, supporting cast around him, it seems to be a bigger problem right now than Carmelo does.
Now, Sekou, the biggest talk in the offseason was the assembly of the Brooklyn Nets team. After basically 3 weeks, give them a grade.
An incomplete, certainly, on the court. You know, they missed a few assignments. They hadn't turned in a couple of assignments. You know, the journal they're supposed to be filling out every day at the end of the school day is clearly not, you know, getting done properly. So, but again, that's another team, poorly constructed, if you ask me. You know, you get Paul Pierce and Kevin Garnett, and you act like you're getting them in their prime. You're getting them 7-8 years ago, and you're getting the old washed-up version. I mean, neither one of them is capable of going out there and playing at the levels that they were, you know, as recently as 5 years ago. And that's not an indictment of them. It's just Father Time whooping that tail again, you know. It happens in every sport. It's going to happen to every star. I don't care who you think you are, you know, but you hit a certain plateau in terms of age. You know, in the NBA, it's kind of an unwritten rule that once you hit your 30th birthday, you know, you start playing on the other side of that mountain. And those guys are experiencing it, and the Brooklyn Nets are paying for it in a lot of ways because, again, they're not constructed to be the same team without contributions from those guys as they are with.
Sekou, good morning. This is Big Kenny. First things first, happy 102 years old. Yesterday was Founders Day for the illustrious Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
I hear you.
Now, the NBA, the league, nor the different franchises will mandate that these athletes stay off of social media. Where
right.
does this fine money go? What do they do with all of the money that they're collecting from these people making these poor choices on social media?
Well, all of the fantastic NBA cares and NBA charity work that gets done is funded by the, you know, solid citizens like Matt Barnes and, and all these dudes who want to use, you know, foolish words on Twitter or threaten somebody on Twitter and all this stuff. I mean, J.R. Smith, these guys, they don't get credit for it, you know, publicly, but they are some of the greatest donors to charity in the country. Because every time one of these jokers gets hit for 25 grand for saying something stupid on Twitter, there's a kid somewhere who's going to get a wish to come true through NBA cares and NBA charities, man. And you know what? I couldn't think of a better way for that money to get used if these guys are going to be that irresponsible with the platform they have and with their actions.
That's a good point. That's a really good point.
Yeah, you hear about the money. It's just under the owner's
right.
charity. Or the right. league will pick certain charities, and that's where they'll send the money that year. So you hear about it. It just doesn't say Matt Barnes.
Right.
It don't say Matt Barnes.
The March of Dimes ought to do a commercial. Thanks for being stupid.
Well, Sekou, at this point in the season, there's two teams that I've kind of witnessed that I think, whether they win or lose, are very competitive. Which out of the Knicks, not the Knicks, out of the Lakers and the Hawks, would you say have been more of a surprise?
Well, obviously, there's any doubt I would say that the Lakers have been more of a surprise, even though they're 5-7. You know, they're still not 500 or better, but most people are writing them off without Kobe. Mm-hmm. You know, and then you get Steve Nash injured and Pau Gasol hobbling around early in the season, and, you know, people would have left them for dead. But it's a, you know, that lets you know, you know, people always talk about tanking and this and the other. For every fool who thinks that a team doesn't want to win or is trying to lose on purpose, there's a Xavier Henry, a Jordan Hill, or some guy who's been waiting on his opportunity to shine in the NBA. And you give them a platform, and these guys are going to smash through it trying to make an impression and prove to people that they are, you know, who they thought they were on draft night or what have you. So I think, like, you know, the Lakers clearly to me are a bigger surprise. I think the Hawks have been a pleasant surprise and have done a good job of assembling those new pieces together and getting off to a good start. But, you know, nobody thought the Lakers would even be treading water right now, and they got a chance to put themselves in a really good position with Kobe coming back at some point in terms of chasing after that last playoff spot in the Western Conference.
Well, Sekou, we thank you for calling in, man, and hopefully we'll get up soon and hang out, do something.
No doubt, stay away from
you. Can you go to the game with me, or is it like
yeah,
that's banned?
Yeah, he got a beer pong tournament coming up.
Oh, yeah,
beer pong.
I'm just saying, stay away from that beer pong, big fella.
Okay, I will. I don't even drink beer, so I'm good. Sekou Smith, NBA TV, NBA.com. We'll be back, 888-926-7562, the sports, that's JOC.com.
Hey, never miss another show. Get the Sports Jock wake-up call at 9 a.m. Sign up at thesportsjoc.com.
More of the Sports Jock Show with Wayne Gandy coming up next.
Hey, over here.
What?
Right here in the back.
Where?
Over by the fence.
You? The bike?
Yeah, the bike. Right in the grass where the kids left me a while ago. You know how lonely it is being left day after day, not being able to cruise the reservation?
Pardon me?
Remember when you got me for the kids? You told them, "No, you kids go have fun, enjoy the outdoors, and be careful."
Yeah?
I really miss it, especially when they put that playing card in my spokes, and I made a really cool sound the faster we went. Well, could you get my tires a little air, dust off my seat, and remind the kids how fun I still am?
Okay. Oh, you are dusty.
Yeah, and I may need a couple of bolts tightened, too. Now let's go.
As Native American parents and caregivers, our encouragement to healthy lifestyles for our kids is helping them get outside and play. Get ideas, get involved, get going at letsmove.gov/IndianCountry. brought to you by USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
Enough is enough! I have had it!
Why so serious?
And behold the world ransom for...
Wayne Andy.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Show me
Broadcasting live from the Armada FM studios in Atlanta, Georgia. This is the Sports Chalk Show with Wayne Gandy.
Welcome back to the Sports Chalk Show. I'm the Sports Chalk Wayne Gandy. We'd like to once again thank our man, Sekou Smith. NBA TV and NBA.com analyst for calling in. Stay away from the beer pong, as we have discussed, or at least as Big Kenny just said, take a good friend to protect you.
Not too good of a friend. you want to have some clearly defined lines for your friendship, but
friends don't let friends beer pong solo.
Tonight's action, Monday Night Football, the New England Patriots will be taking on the Carolina Panthers. Monday Night Football going great. Two good teams, the Patriots 7-2. Carolina surprisingly sitting there at 6-3. This would be a huge win for them, Cam Newton and the boys. War Eagle, Cam Newton, another War Eagle. See, I'm getting the War Eagle in everywhere. I can just keep War Eagling all day long. Yes, you're going to hear it. We got two more hours. You're going to hear it. There's the play. I'm going to play it in a minute just because you made that noise, guy. Yesterday, you'd rather watch that play than what we're about to talk about. The Falcons and the Bucks. Wouldn't you rather watch that play, Big Kenny, than...
Well, I would just like to ask a question, or sure. Maybe it's sort of... I think it's interesting that Auburn seems to be very, very much in favor of the second chance.
Mm-hmm.
Nick Marshall is down there doing big things now. Second chance guy.
Mm-hmm.
Cam Newton was down there doing big things. Second chance guy. Who's responsible for that culture of willing to give a guy the benefit of the doubt?
I think the whole institution, the sports program, Auburn, and I know, and when I was there, they were big junior college recruiters. They would go and get those guys and bring them there. I played with a guy named Eddie Blake on the offensive line. Gary Walker, we got from Hines Junior College. He ended up playing there 2 years after junior college, going to the pros, played about 8 years. It's just every team, I think, has their different angle in which they get players. Auburn has never been shy of going to get junior college players. Auburn has never been shy of the black quarterback.
Right.
So whereas some schools have that stigma that they don't do this and don't do that, Auburn in those ways have always dealt. They went and got Brandon... What's the guy named? Played for the Giants, the running back. Brandon, the big number 27. He left, came back now.
Yeah.
Big old power running back. I can't remember. He came from a junior college. Auburn went and got him. So they've always went and got those guys. And Nick Marshall is just another guy in that line of people that they have brought, a la Cam Newton.
How do they restructured their thinking? Because I believe Nick Marshall got in trouble for some larceny type
activity. At Georgia.
Right, mm-hmm. At Georgia. Cam Newton had an air of impropriety surrounding him. How is it that Auburn's able to get them there and just totally rehabilitate their thinking process?
Well, I think a lot of those kids, especially once they have, you have to imagine you go to a Georgia where everything is in your locker, all the amenities are there for you. You get in trouble, now you end up at Big Kenny's Community College, where you're having to lace your own sneakers.
Right.
You understand?
Where you're having to buy your own sneakers.
Yeah, you're sitting there, like, you know, and wash your own uniform.
Right.
So when that guy that calls again and says, hey, you want to come back to the promised land? You know, it's kind of that kind of situation. If the player is smart, he's going to take advantage, because it wasn't his talent that got him pushed down.
Right.
It was his act. In cases that we have had, it has worked out. Now, I'm quite sure there are some cases where it didn't go the way it should have gone, but Auburn has done a great job of building relationships with that junior college circuit to be able to go get those guys. And it's been Brandon Jacobs is the guy's name.
Okay.
Remember Brandon Jacobs?
Yep.
Big, he went to Auburn for a year. We got him from a junior college. Right. So it's worked out well. And they've never been, that's what I'm saying, even when I was there, they would go get, and sometimes you found out that this guy was number one, number two at his position coming out of high school. He just ended up in some kind of trouble at a junior college. They go get him. And I think Nick Farley maybe even was at a junior college, the D tackle that ended up with the Lions. Right. I think he was at a junior college as well. Real quickly, as I said, we won't harp on it long. Falcons dismantled in Tampa. Would y'all say that's an accurate word? If you, what would you use? One word, Big Kenny?
Fire. That's just my fear. Fire somebody. Yeah, that would be. That's all I think about now.
You just think somebody has to go.
Somebody needs to go.
It's embarrassment.
Embarrassing. I would say just dismantled. I watched the game. Tampa won offensively. They won defensively. They won the special teams. I didn't see any aspect of the game that the Falcons actually won. Tampa did everything they wanted to, and this is a team that only had one win. Now they've equaled. I mean, the Falcons are 2-8. I don't think people really realize that. They have six games to go. I looked at the remaining six games. They got the Saints this Thursday night. They have San Francisco down the road, out in San Francisco. They got Green Bay in Green Bay, which is probably going to be snowing. I think Cam and them come here at the end of the year. The Redskins come here. So you look at their schedule, how it goes. 4-12?
Wow.
I mean, it wouldn't be a bar, and Big Kenny said they might not win another game.
And this is what I wanted to ask. Do you think that the Falcons have begun to believe all of the negative press surrounding them? Because yesterday they played a team that they should have beaten.
Right.
But they were dominated in this game. I mean, you wouldn't expect the Tampa Bay Buccaneers to score 41 points this season.
All season.
In the rest of the remaining schedule.
In the rest of the remaining schedule. But they scored 41 on the Falcons yesterday and treated them like they were a Super Bowl contention.
Right. With a backup running back, a backup quarterback, and they treated them like they were really the 1-18.
Right.
And when you look at this game, it just was no area that the Falcons won. And I can't say impressed that enough. Bobby Rainey, for y'all that don't even know, I didn't know, went to Western Kentucky. I don't even think he was drafted. Just running up and down. I thought it was Chris Rainey at one point. but it's just
and
a bad situation. And the thing, too, now it becomes psychological because – people never really realize, kind of like how Georgia was, the Bulldogs. When you kind of average, you start thinking, I just want to make the playoffs. And then when you get a team like the Falcons, last couple of years, it was, I just want to get to the Super Bowl. This year, it was, no, not just get to the Super Bowl, win it. When that has been wiped away, a lot of people start diving off the ship because it's like, that's just all we had in our mind. Being 8-8, being 6-10, it seems like that way. Like, it doesn't matter now. Since we're not going to be Super Bowl, who cares? And that's kind of how you see the game. Real quickly, we got Jared on hold. It's funny, he calls in early when his team get a victory. Jared, what would you like to say about this game?
It's not that I called in early because they got a victory. Stop it. I call in during football hour.
Then why are you laughing today? Last week you weren't laughing.
Last week he was on suicide watch.
Oh, man. This is the thing I'd say. This is the type of thing that makes me sick because, you know, they're 4-6 and the rest of the Mire and the AFC for that last piece is all like 4-6 or 5-5. So they're going to make you hang in there and pay attention for the rest of the season because everybody else stinks that's going to be at that 6 seed. So, you know, it's more torture. You know, and they're going to end up being, you know, 7-9 or just missing it by one game, and you're going to be like, okay. That's the whole thing. And then this new quarterback who they pulled off, you know, he was on the practice squad, throws 3 touchdowns at. You know, what does that say about all the other idiots they had in there playing quarterback?
That they were idiots. <That's what> But, yes, I don't even know who Matt McGloin is. Is that how you say his last name?
Yeah, McGloin. He's from Penn State. He was there during the boy touching days.
The boy touching days.
His name McGloin or McGroin?
Is Matt McGloin playing against the Houston Texans, who I think is kind of the Atlanta of the AFC, in the AFC, a team that at the beginning of the season you figured them and Denver were probably the front runners, and now that they are not going to accomplish that mission, the wheels have come off. You see Andre Johnson about to slap Matt Schaub yesterday at the game. It's a lot of infighting. Gary Kubiak has to go. That's the first. When Big Kenny says time to start firing people, it's time to get Kubiak out of there. The Kubiak experience is over. They've gone out, spent a lot of money, Schaub, because that's what I always tell you. When you go and tell the owner, give him the $100 million, that's when your job is on the line, because I got a guy that I can't get rid of, that I got to keep playing, Gary Kubiak. It'll be very surprising if he's there next year, but he is getting healthy. Remember, he had a little seizure or stroke. I think he just don't want to be out there with them anymore. But, Jared, thank you for calling in. Congratulations to your Raiders, 28-23 over the Houston Texans. We'll be back after this with more of the Sports Jock Show. We're going to pull out some weave or dreadlocks or something. I mean, football. I don't know. 888-926-7562. The Sports Jock. That's JOC.com.
Hey, you want a chance to attend the Falcons game with the best seats in the house? Register to get the...
Be a dad today. Call 877-4-DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
This is Nnamdi Asamoah. I play football for the Philadelphia Eagles, but what I do off the field with United Way might be more important. I'm a volunteer tutor and mentor. Why? Because over 1 million kids a year drop out of school, and that's not okay. It takes 12 years to create a graduate, but it takes about the same time to create a dropout. And the difference between a child becoming one or the other could be me, or it could be you. Studies show that if we get to these kids earlier, their chances are better. And kids who read well by third grade are more likely to graduate. So join me in United Way. Suit up and take the pledge. Become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor. Because when a child succeeds, we all succeed. Give. Advocate. Volunteer. Live United. Take the pledge at unitedway.org. Brought to you by United Way, the Ad Council, and the National Football League.
Your busy lifestyle demands performance.
This week's episode.
Here?
Hey!
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. I'm the Sports Jock, Wayne Candy. The Dow Jones average 16,016. That makes me smile. It should make you smile, too, especially you 401k people. We're doing great in 2013. Nobody else is chiming in. Crickets. I was just giving a little money financial report. We report on everything else. Right. Y'all guys ain't with the...
Dow Jones, yay.
The S&P is at 1,800, all-time high. And the NASDAQ is almost at 4,000. Just a little information. I'd like to give you a little bit of everything, not just sports around here.
Do we have a sports stock 401k?
That'll be coming in 2017 with the new stadium.
And since we've been... And since we're giving all kind of information, prices on that good have become regulated and leveled out from an all-time high of $365 down to $250. That hard is making a comeback.
That hard is coming back. We have my former college teammate, Mr. Kelsey Crook, in the building. Before we talk about his new gym, let's show his ad. No? There we go. N10CT. Tell us the story behind the name.
Intensity. I actually created Intensity while at Auburn back in 1993. During the pledge period with Kappa Alpha Psi, I was...
Yo, Newt.
It's always a good one somewhere.
War Eagle.
Cue sci-fi to the day I die.
What's that?
I taste cheese on honey. Y'all got mine? I threw mine out there, too. All right. Dow Jones.
That's the big frat. Yeah. The money frat.
Yeah.
Now that's the one you want to be a part of.
So as you was pledging, so all that running we was doing wasn't enough.
It actually added to the fuel of the fire to come up with the idea of intensity. While online and playing, we was doing spring training. It was prior to the season, the undefeated season.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time I was a junior in college, and taking some of my major courses to graduate. And I was looking for jobs, just preliminary interviewing, and I had a guy ask me a question about, if you could be an animal, what animal would you be? Now, the most logical question would be a tiger or an eagle being an Auburn, so I couldn't make that answer. So I'm not an animal, no, but one word that could identify me would be intensity. And it kind of caught him off guard, but it basically conveyed to him that I'm not an animal, but I'm a person of intense being. And that intense being came from me not only being on the field, being focused about wanting to be a better player at Auburn and wanting to win at Auburn, as well as going through the pledge period. And I just had guys that would always mention the word, "Guy, you're intense, dude. You're very intense." And I said, "There's something about this word. And one day I'm going to have a business, and regardless of what it is, I'm going to name it Intensity." And being so fortunate to stay close into the athletic arena, personal training came natural. And Intensity Fitness perfectly fits personal training.
Do you put them through the same rigors in which we went through?
Can they handle that? And it would not be fair.
That's what I'm talking about. You get locked up for what they were doing to us, Big Kenny.
Oh, yeah.
Now, that was real bullying, you know.
Right. Oh.
Yeah, they put the garbage can over there, and you got to...
I remember that.
That was... Yeah,
Great stories.
Get Coach Dye in jail today for that stuff.
But he made good men of us.
So where's your gym? When is it opening? When can I come take a free class?
You can come take a free class this afternoon, as well as bring your...
I'm a little tired right now. I'm not going to be intense when I leave.
You don't have to worry about being intense. That's what I'm there for. I'm there to help you get intense. Well, we're on 937 Main Street in the village of Stone Mountain. We're right there across from, if you're familiar with the village of Stone Mountain, we're very close to Stone Mountain Park, right across from the old courthouse.
Mm-hmm.
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I will be doing an open house. Friday, the open house will be in the mornings from 7 to 11. We want to kind of catch people as they're going to work to stop by, peek your head in there, see what we're doing, see what we're about, and see what we can do to help you. On Saturday, we plan on being there the whole day from 8 to 3. I'll have other vendors there to hopefully accommodate anyone interested that come by and take a visit at the gym. Sunday, we're going to look for the after-church crowd and the late-evening crowd from 2 to 6. We're just asking everyone to come out, show your face, see how intensely, as well as other fellow trainers there, D. Renard, who's my business partner there. He does training as well, so it'll give you an opportunity to see who I'm working with as business partners, see what Intensity has to offer you, and look forward to helping you in creating a different living and a healthy lifestyle.
Now, how does this differ from CrossFit? Like, what is your training? You know, everybody's into that CrossFit craze, and is that part of your workout regimen as well?
No, we're not really a CrossFit gym per se. We may do some exercises, run some exercise routines that are very similar to CrossFit. But what I try to do, I have a program, and it's basically start where you are, use what you have, and do the best you can. I mean, at any level of fitness, you can come in and work out. And the program that I run is called the Levels of Levels of Intensity, which allows you, if you're at a level one, you can work out with someone at a level five. But level five will have a higher intensity, which means they may be doing exercises with weights. They may have a shorter rest time. But it allows a group to come in at different fitness levels and be able to work out and to enjoy each other's company, as well as reach another level of intensity to strive to reach that level two, level three, to try to get to that, or try to compete against that next person in there. So what I wanted to do was combine some competition within the exercise program that I created to inspire you to want to get better and to give you a goal at getting better, and for me to be there to help you get to that next level.
Now, fitness industry is like a $1 billion industry, right? It's a huge, big money in fitness and weight loss, but it seems like it would be saturated, you know, with the LA Fitnesses and all these other gyms all around. Like, how do you, where's your niche? How do you fit in, you know, and how do you differentiate intensity from any of those other gyms?
I'm glad you asked that question. I fit my philosophy of intensity into, it's not only a lifestyle of healthy eating, exercising, but it's a lifestyle of promoting success in other areas of, in other human endeavors, which means that once you are healthy and you're confident in yourself and how you look and how you feel, that health, that confidence rolls over to other areas of your life. And even in your family life, you're happier to be at home, most likely. It increases your relationship with your spouse, girlfriend. You're a happier person at work, because it actually increases energy. A lot of times people come in and say, I can't work out, it's going to make me tired. Actually, it increases your energy. And with intensity, the definition of intensity is nothing more than exceptional, great concentration, energy, or focus, especially in activity. Now, activity is in anything. You can be an intense Bible reader. You can be an intense football player. You can be an intense comedian. It's nothing more than adding focus to what you're doing. And by adding that little bit of intensity, it will make you successful. There's no one that has been successful without applying intensity, because you have to focus on what you want to do. So my clients, when you come in, I want you to be focused on the exercises that we're doing them correctly, and focusing on giving your best level of intensity, and you will see change.
And then your food program, because as we went to break, we were talking about how, you know, the U.S. basically has a obesity problem, especially in the teenage and high school ages. What is your first thing? You know how you meet up with a trainer and they want to take away everything. By the time you leave, all you can do is graze like a cow because they've taken everything else away. How do you start your meal programs and things like that?
Remember what I was saying in the beginning. Start where you are, use what you have, and do the best you can. I don't think it's a successful way of coming to someone and asking them to go cold turkey, stop eating all this thing. What you create in them is an opportunity for failure. And once you create an opportunity for failure, failure follows right after failure follows quitting. I can't do it. This is too hard. So the program that I have is basically, it's a meal schedule eating program, which means I'm not going to tell you what to eat at certain points of the day, because you may not like that. And if you don't like it, you're not going to eat it. And either you're going to lie to me or lie to yourself, and it's going to show in your improvement in the weight room as well as in your cardiovascular activities as well. So what I have is a meal eating plan which tells you at the time of day what to eat. There's a five times eating and six times eating. What I tell you during those times is a breakfast, mid-morning snack, lunch, mid-afternoon snack, supper for those that eat early, and dinner for those that eat after 8 o'clock, and a late-night snack for those that may stay up late and working late. In each of those categories, I tell you to eat what a protein, carb, vegetable, fruit, water. And there's a list of all these items that I have named of what you should eat under the grocery list that we provide as well. So I try to make it every opportunity for you to be successful by providing you what to eat at certain times of day, as well as a grocery list to shop from these things. If you have that grocery list, the items are in your refrigerator, so why not eat them? But then I get a lot of clients saying, what did I do with the food that's left in here? Give it to somebody that's homeless, that's hungry. Don't just go through it and eat it and put yourself in a deeper hole than what you're starting out at.
Gotcha. And what kind of meal plan, real quickly, are you on? What don't you eat?
This is my off season per se, football season. But I have been pretty good. I've been eating more of a peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, and the jelly is usually low sugar, or sometimes just a peanut butter sandwich.
That's your cheat.
Actually, that is, and this is weird. For a week, I eat maybe a peanut butter and jelly sandwich 3 times a day, and I forgot my gallon of water. I usually have a gallon of water with me. This is when I'm going extremely strict. And then I just keep it at fruit and vegetables, grapefruits, green beans, brown rice, corn on the cob. I don't eat a whole lot of different vegetables. It's everything is kind of like my favorite things that are healthy, and I keep them on the, and I keep them in the
I don't have any of what you just said at my house.
But I'll tell you what I have that is great. I have a
I'm gonna drink my sweet tea and live in all these calories.
Right, put some lemon in it to kind of give it a little bit of a healthy edge.
And I'm gonna have me a slab of ribs later today.
Well, I'll see you at the gym this evening, sir.
Intensity, Kelsey Crook, thank you for stopping in.
Thank you for having me.
War Eagle to you, Stone Mound. 888-926, we will have your, put his location up on our website, and we will make sure we mention it later in the show as we end. We'll be back with more of the Sports Shock Show right after this break. Peanut butter sandwiches, man.
Hey, Wayne Gandy's commentary is up in minutes. It's the Ocean segment. Who will go in the ocean today? Keep listening to find out on the sportsjoc.com.
Brew! 81! Ice cold brew!
That was a heck of a sack.
Chicken wings? Ice cold brews? You know, Bob, he might want to hit the showers and head to Hooters.
Hooters is your one-stop shop for food, fun, and fantasy football.
Get your very own fantasy football draft kit and keep up-to-the-minute stats with Hooters' totally free Wi-Fi.
Great food, great fun, and your very own cheerleaders, the world-famous Hooters girls.
Hooters! Visit HootersDraftParty.com to book your party.
Your busy lifestyle demands performance. Energy drinks and shots can be an acquired taste and can cause jitters, crashes, and even stomach discomfort. The new 8-Hour Energy Patch is the natural, sugar, and calorie-free alternative to energy drinks, shots, and even coffee. It's the only energy that sticks. Just 2 time-release patches will keep you going at work, the gym, or even a night out. No unpleasant taste, jitters, or crashes. For a 12-hour boost, just add another patch. For only 4 hours, use one. You're in charge. Visit 8hourenergy.com for more info and your free sample. Do not exceed 3 patches per day.
It's not always easy being a dad.
When's the fairy princess coming?
Any minute now.
What? What do you mean she's not coming?
But it's always worth it.
It's the fairy princess!
It is I!
Grooves! Zinkerbell!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
I know it's really you, Drew. I'm just pretending for the other kids.
Take time to be a dad today. Call 877-4-DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
You are a waste. A loser. Everyone hates you. Why don't you just stay in your car and keep driving? I'm serious. Drive until you run out of gas and get out of your car and walk until you find someone who doesn't think you're dumber than bricks. Could take a while, but at least all that walking might burn a couple of calories.
You may not witness bullying like this every day. Your kids do. They want to help, but they don't know how. Visit stopbullying.gov to learn safe, simple ways your child can help stop bullying. Be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov. A message from the Ad Council.
Hey, over here.
What?
Right here in the back.
Where?
Over by the fence.
You? The bike?
Yeah, the bike. Right in the grass where the kids left me a while ago. You know how lonely it is being left day after day, not being able to cruise the reservation?
Pardon me?
Remember when you got me for the kids? You told them, "Now you kids go have fun, enjoy the outdoors, and be careful."
Yeah?
I really miss it, especially when they put that playing card in my spokes, and I made a really cool sound the faster we went. Well, could you get my tires a little air, dust off my seat, and remind the kids how fun I still am?
Okay. Oh, you are dusty.
Yeah, and I may need a couple of bolts tightened, too. Now let's go.
As Native American parents and caregivers, our encouragement to healthy lifestyles for our kids is helping them get outside and play. Get ideas, get involved, get going at letsmove.gov/Indian Country. Brought to you by USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
And now back to the Sports Jock, Wayne Gantz.
Sports Jock Show. I'm the Sports Jock, Wayne Gandy. We were just sitting here talking to Intensity's K. Kelsey Crook. Kelsey, I want you to join the show on this next video that I have. Young high school player, Tony Picard. He's a running back for Washington High School. Here is Tony running the ball. That is Tony right there, the big guy. He's 6'4", he's 400 pounds. He is, why are you looking at me like
no,
that?
No, I've seen the video already. I'm just.
He is a running back in high school. That is when he's coming through. That is, I guess that's the safety right there, number three. And even in that picture, the safety looks like he really doesn't know how I'm going to attack this guy. Can't y'all read that in his body language? Or maybe it's just me that he's staying at number three. I don't know which way to go. As you can see, it's a big man.
Number three thinking, would it really be a bad thing if he scored right now? would I have that much responsibility for stopping him on my shoulders?
He can run the ball in high school. That can work for a couple of plays. If there's any college in the future, he definitely would have to move to the O or D line. That's not going to help. And we were just talking about obesity problem. I don't care how that looks fantastic. There shouldn't be a kid in high school that's 400 pounds.
At all.
Can we all not agree on that? Like,
we agree.
Yeah. Well, there shouldn't be a person walking, period. How about that?
That's 400.
That's 400 pounds.
Unless you're Andre the Giant or someone.
But you got to be 8'2".
Yeah, you got to have some kind
of. Yeah, so he was 8 feet tall. So unless you get measured at 8 feet. Which I don't think, but maybe two or three people a century get that kind of height.
A century.
But his mom and dad definitely, because this could easily turn into a sad story.
Yeah.
Him being that big. And I got other photos where he's really it's funny and it's fun to laugh at. And yes, he's out there bullying kids. But health-wise, it's a bad, bad, bad situation in that right there.
Now, is there any weight of responsibility that falls upon a coach that sees a kid like that and goes, I could use that? You know what I mean? Do you think that they give him any instruction on making yourself more healthy? Let's try and get some of that weight off you, make you a little more mobile. Or do you think it's, hey, don't stop eating because I can win a championship this season?
I definitely wouldn't think it would be don't stop eating. I don't know if they offer advice because we just talked this whole show about people being sensitive. If I say the wrong word, you go home, tell your dad. Next thing I know, they're trying to fire me, talking about I was calling you a name or something. Coaches used to take more responsibility. Now, at the college level, yes, because they can actually punish you for weight. At the high school level, not so much. You know, we used to get punished. You could get punished in college in my day for being underweight or overweight. Mm-hmm. So I told you to be 200. You keep coming here at 195, which is crazy because I'm going to make you run.
Right.
But I want you to gain weight. But that's how they used to punish you. Yeah, like, right. Why aren't you gaining weight? I mean, so it worked both ways back then. Now, that's what I'm saying, as we keep saying, the game has gotten solved. I don't know what the rules are. Yeah, it's like you almost can't even talk to a kid anymore without somebody trying to pull a lawsuit or say that you're bullying or suspend you. So, and I think that's where you're going to have the coaches go. The coaches are going to be, you know, coaches used to supposed to present just like a big uncle or a dad. Now it's like, don't say nothing to my kid. So, hopefully, in this case, they can talk him down at least 80 pounds. I mean, because he's big. I mean, at my biggest, I was like
3'10".
Right.
And that was in the eighth grade.
No, in high school, I was only 250.
Right.
So, which at that time was a big person. But that's huge. And if you're able to hold 400 pounds and play sports, you're doing a whole lot of eating
right.
to keep that kind of weight. So we'll see where this goes for Mr. Picard. Another sweet moment happened in sports. After the UCLA game, one of the players decided that he wanted to propose. This is UCLA and the proposal. You can't really hear the audio that great. The UCLA player is, this is after they won the game. Jim Morrill and his guys are still out on the field. And the kid gets down on a knee. And he has his girlfriend, which I'm quite sure that she knew that something was up. Because as you can see in the crowd, she's the only girl really out there. So she did say yes in the video. I don't know where all these guys' shirts are. yeah. Big Kenny. It's kind of sweet, though.
No, right? It ain't. No, it ain't. Ain't nothing sweet about the contrived proposal. I get so sick of dudes. I get so sick. Is there nobody that loves this dude enough to hold him down and punch him in the nose and tell him, hey, man, that's something between you and that woman? I get so sick
so
of dudes.
So you're not with those at
no,
the game?
Stop. We ain't got to shoot a video. I get 100 of my friends together, and we all dance, and then somebody jumps out of a plane, and then it becomes a viral video. These over-the-top proposals, mm-hmm. Come on, man. Don't make a spectacle out of it. I mean, first of all, it ought to be genuine. It ought to be heartfelt,
right.
And there, to me, is little. I don't feel the same about your lady the way you feel about your lady. How you gonna get me to dance with you and then, you know, I gotta hold up a sign and we all dress alike and
right.
that to me is so. And then you putting pressure on this woman who might be in the, hey, maybe we could wait a couple of years. We only been dating 4 months. You know what I'm saying? Maybe she would say that if you asked her in private, but now you doing it on the Jumbotron.
So Stan McKay is wrong in this.
Yeah, Stan McKay is wrong. And everybody that's involved with him.
His mom is right there with him.
Punch her too.
She's standing right there. That's the mom right there with the scarf. They just won this game. This is UCLA Bruins. They won 41-31 over Washington Huskies on Friday night. Guy, what do you think about the stage proposal?
That's good. I wouldn't do it. Like, I think, like you said, it's supposed to be a special moment between two people. Now, I mean, you're going to remember that, I suppose. You know, I mean,
yeah, especially when you get a divorce. Like, wow, we went through all of this and it only lasted 2 months. And then, you know, a lot of what's happening
now.
You
got a real issue with this.
No, I'm serious, man, because now what's happening with a lot of these situations
uh-huh.
is because of social media and things like that. The people involved feel like the love ain't real if the video doesn't go viral. Oh, we only got 10,000 hits on that. You know what I mean?
Right.
And now she's all upset with him because all we got is 10,000 hits. You don't really love me because you're not promoting it enough. It's not that
this
serious.
And what's interesting, this happens at least two or three times a basketball season. I go to the Hawks game. They do this at least two or three times. They'll bring the guy out like he's going to play the little interactive games that they have. And at the end, he'll get on the knee and ask the girl to marry him.
Last week, a buddy of mine that is a comedian as well had me help him structure a set based around being on stage and proposing to his fiance from the stage. And, you know, more power to him. She said yes. I'm all for love, but, you know, me, I'm just hey, what you doing next week?
Kelsey, since you're an intense man, can you see this working for you? Is this something you would do?
I don't know. That's, like you said, you put a lot of pressure on the lady. You put a lot of pressure on
the So y'all the thing that the pressure makes her say yes when it's really a no?
if she loves you and not maybe want to marry you, she'll say yes, so it won't embarrass you, so you won't be.
Can you imagine
10 million bow if she said no?
Can you imagine her looking at him and going, I don't feel like that about you?
Hey, now that'll go viral.
In a situation like that, this dude would be so destroyed for the rest of his life.
Give me back my Letterman jacket.
But he'll be famous.
That does look like his Letterman jacket in the video.
Yeah, it does.
But he did have enough to have his mom out there present, which probably put a lot of pressure on her as well.
Oh, yeah.
Because mama would have swung on her.
We went from pressure to intimidation.
Yeah, it would have been real viral if she had said no.
Or would have been on some, I told you not to ask her, no way. She went.
Now we have a reality show, huh?
UCLA Stan McKay proposing.
Hey, let's remember that.
To his girlfriend after the game, won the game. He's a senior linebacker, so this is his last season at UCLA. Just funny what goes on in sports now.
I have a question. Would he have asked if they lost?
Good question. What's that old Arsenio Hall thing? Things that make you go,
Might have waited till they won a game.
Maybe that's what he would have done. Kept the ring until then. 888-926-7562. The Sports Jock at thesportsjock.com. We'll be back with the ocean. We got right up to the ocean, man. It's a quick show.
Wow.
Bye, guy.
Hey, Wayne Gandy commentary is up in minutes. It's the ocean segment. Who will go into the ocean today? Keep listening to find out on thesportsjoc.com.
Hey, Dad, how do you throw a curveball? How do you build a fort? How do refrigerators run? How do fish learn how to swim?
Kids ask a lot of questions.
How high can you jump?
But you don't have to know every answer.
How many phone numbers are there?
Because you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent.
How do cell phones work?
There are thousands of children in foster care who don't need every question answered.
What's electricity?
They just need you.
What's the moon made of?
For more information on how you can adopt, go to AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt U.S. Kids, and the Ad Council.
It's not always easy being a dad.
When's the fairy princess coming?
Any minute now.
What? What do you mean she's not coming?
But it's always worth it.
It's the fairy princess!
It is I!
Groove! Zinkelbell!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
I know it's really you, Drew. I'm just pretending for the other kids.
Take time to be a dad today. Call 877-4-DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
You are a waste, a loser. Everyone hates you. Why don't you just stay in your car and keep driving? I'm serious. Drive until you run out of gas, then get out of your car and walk until you find someone who doesn't think you're dumber than bricks. Could take a while, but at least all that walking might burn a couple of calories.
You may not witness bullying like this every day. Your kids do. They want to help, but they don't know how. Visit stopbullying.gov to learn safe, simple ways your child can help stop bullying. Be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov. A message from the Ad Council.
Sassy! Sassy!
This week's episode, Rattlesnake at the Pond.
Oh, Johnny, skipping rocks at the pond sure is fun.
Hey, look, a moving stick.
That ain't a stick. That's a rattlesnake.
Sassy, we're in danger.
Good idea, Sassy. Go get Mr. Gunderson.
You will in a second, but first you'd like to tell us something we may not know about animal shelters in the United States?
It's getting close, Sassy.
Approximately 8 million pets enter shelters each year? The majority of which are in shelters because of owner-related issues that the animals have no control over?
Sassy, the rattlesnake! Save us, Sassy!
What, Sassy? You wish you were videotaping this? Sassy!
Sassy is brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org. Remember, adopt!
This is Lisa Edelstein from House. On TV, the good doctors aren't always easy to spot, but it is easy to spot the good that Barasa Ware is doing as a local health worker in Ethiopia. Every day, he helps the children of his village survive. When you help local health workers like Barasa, you're one step away from helping children survive all over the world. See where the good goes at goodgoes.org and find out all the ways you can help the good go further. Brought to you by Save the Children and the Ad Council.
And now, back to the Sports Jock, Wayne Gandy.
Big booty. Can I say it? Y'all sure?
Might as well.
Can I say whores? I can't say the word whores. I said whores. That's not, you can't say that. Isn't that
big booty women of low more fiber.
Good producer. You said I can't say that word. So I can't use any variation of that word. Really?
Big booty trollops.
Jezebel. I mean.
Trumpets.
It's got to be some big booty trumpets.
There's
some
whores
in this house. Broad shit.
I tell you, man. I see why you're leaving, Frosty.
What part of the game is that?
What part of the game is that? I tell you. real quickly, the BCS new standing is out. One thing we didn't talk about that. Oklahoma State at 10. Stanford at 9 after losing the other night. Missouri at 8. Clemson at 7. Auburn 6. Oregon 5, Baylor 4, Ohio State is 3, Jameis Winston and his rape charge is at 2, and Alabama as 1, but in Jameis Winston's defense, the girl in her description of who raped her, wow. It doesn't fit the bill of Jameis Winston. Amen. She said it was 5'9 to about 5'11". Jameis Winston is 6'4", so
I give you that far off.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Hey, man, trust me, it's a lot of people never fit the description, end up going to jail. So Jameis Winston, don't write it off. You know what I'm saying? Get you a good lawyer, don't get relaxed. Don't start looking down. Down the field to the BCS championship or something, because you might not make it.
That's the thing, but tying his name to stuff like that. I mean, he as a freshman,
mm-hmm.
has a good shot at winning the Heisman until
mm-hmm. stuff like that comes out. Right. I'd like to send out a shout to my GAC Spartans Division II playoffs. They'll be taking on Calhoun this Friday in the second round of the playoffs. They won Friday 34-0. They beat Rayburn County. Yes, I will shout them out because I send money there. So if you send money, y'all got somewhere y'all sending money to?
Nope.
James Madison University.
There you go. We both shout them.
James Madison. I don't know how well they doing.
But you're going to shout them out.
In the sports program, but... my boy's getting that biology degree. Much love to them.
They deserve a shout out when they're taking your money. Massengill said to Georgia Power. They want to shout out Georgia Power. the World Anti-Doping Agency passed 2 significant new rules. 1, drug cheats will be banned from competition for 4 years now instead of 2. So they're making sure that you miss the next Olympics if you're caught. And 2, they're offering athletes possible immunity from punishment in return for substantial info on doping and any incentives for helping them find other people that are doping. And basically, they're rewarding you for snitching. In layman's terms.
And it's so subjective for
how do you make a
substantial
rule
information. What does that mean? Substantial. If the name is big enough, an allegation may be just substantial. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. If it's somebody that really don't matter, then you got to go out and you got to catch this dude with the needle in his thigh or something. You know what I mean?
Right.
This is just so ridiculous.
You made a rule to advocate snitching.
You can see all these Yugoslavian women walking into the office like, I have something I need to tell you. Boris, I see he get muscular over days. He don't know how it happens.
There's Bryant of the Cowboys last week while he was at Walmart waiting on his brand new PS4. Decided to buy a couple of the customers some PS4. PS4s as well. He claims that he's the world's best Madden video game player. The PS4, I guess, is new. I've never played PlayStation.
I hope he's studying that Dallas Cowboy playbook on PS4.
Oh,
I'm a Cowboy fan.
Oh, man. That's what the guy is moving to Dallas. So
wonderful city. I lived there a couple of years.
Is it? Okay.
Yes, he's going to be a Cowboy fan.
I'm eager to check it out. I'm eager to get there and get on CBS. It's going to be a lot of fun going back to sports. But back to Dez.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe this will take a little attention off slapping his mama.
Oh, there he is right there in the... You always got to have that peace and prison sign pose. Man, just take your PS4 and go home.
Exactly.
Oh, you got to look. You got to look thug in a picture with Dez. He slapped his mama. You can't be holding no teddy bear. Stu slapped his moms. You got to be about that life in a picture with Dez.
Dude, that is true. That is true. Right. LeBron James Jr. was in the news last week as well. LeBron's little son is doing big things. Scored 25 points.
Wow.
In his little league game. Looked like his dad a little bit out there. You even see him in that commercial that LeBron has, right, playing a little hoop together. We do have a little video of them. Don't give me that church finger. Both already. I sent you the information to have it ready.
What is the pre-production meeting about? Why do we do that again? Why do we come in extra early and get all of this stuff together?
And he harasses me on Sunday.
Oh, you know he does.
Any video?
Dude sends me emails at 1:40 in the morning knowing that we get here at 7:30 a.m.
I guess we don't have it, but hopefully we'll get it up soon. But his son...
It's guyless.
He holds that hand. You know, sometimes LeBron dribbles with his hands right here. He just emulates his dad. Hey, why not? You know.
It might not just be guy who's on his last day today. You know what I mean? We cleaning house at the Sports Jock Show.
LeBron James Jr. He is leading the team in scoring. And
if he wasn't,
right,
would there be like a lot of pressure on this dude? Like, man, you LeBron's son, what are you doing?
Right. Shoot the ball. He'd be getting the same criticism. Take the last shot.
Take the last shot. But I'm not even on your team. Take the shot.
I want to see you take the shot. They do get criticized. In other news, since we're not going to be able to watch LeBron James Jr. do his thing, will you hit the table and say no? Oh, he does have it now? No? Yes? Okay, quickly, or do I need to change...
gears.
Yeah, guy, you take him on with you. This is LeBron James Jr. Let me see if we can find him. Number 6, as his dad is.
Were they double teaming him?
Yeah, they're sponsored by Nike, as you would imagine. They're all clean. They ain't had them kind of little league outfits. Look at him. Running hard like his dad in the layup line.
Is that Juwan
Howard?
Juwan
Howard down there giving some spiked water. Little coaching, fresh fade. Yeah, I bought you that uniform, boy. You know how it's going down. Big Kenny, you know we ain't used to have no good-looking uniforms like that. Duke University right there.
Everybody wear a white T-shirt and some black shorts. Some of them had cut-off black shorts that went to jeans, you know, but...
They out there looking like a real college team. Real quickly, before we go, shout-out to our man Sekou for calling in as well. Thank you for coming through, Kelsey, telling us about intensity.
Thank you.
Real quick, this picture I want you to see of the strip club mogul. He bought the house right next to his ex-wife. And in the front, he put the finger up so she could see it every day. That statue right there is of the middle finger. That's what he thinks about his ex-wife. You're talking about some true hate. I found you. I bought the house next to you. And I built a statue that shows you the finger.
The one
that is true
thin line between
true hate.
No, now she feel like she still matter. You know what I'm saying?
But she got to explain that to every guy she brings over.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, that just
every guy comes.
He can't get over me. He bought a house right next to me, and he wants to just you.
But
know.
That would scare me though, because at some point I'm thinking if he do that. He might come over here some at point.
Because she still matters to him.
That's what I mean.
She still matters to
and
him.
And he come over here with that thing, you know, how they do it, suicide. The mass suicide, kill both of us, and then kill himself. I mean, to spend that kind of energy right there with the finger.
And money.
And money to do that. A mansion on the lake.
Man up. You own strip clubs.
Mogul.
You're a mogul of strip clubs. Why not just get the night shift?
But we are in the ocean, though, real quickly.
The truth is, he will throw your ass in the ocean. It's time to wrap things up on the Sports Jock Show with Wayne Gandy.
When you hear the sounds of the ocean, it gives the sports jock just a moment to vent. We'd like to thank our man Kelsey Crook for stepping in. Intensity, I'm going to send one of the interns to work out up there. Sekou Smith, NBA TV. I don't have an ocean candidate, but I do have this for you. Can I see that Auburn play just one more time? Take me home, Nick Marshall.
Three-man rush. Let's it go.
And the difference between a child becoming one or the other could be me, or it could be you. Studies show that if we get to these kids earlier, their chances are better. And kids who read well by third grade are more likely to graduate. So join me in United Way. Suit up and take the pledge. Become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor. Because when a child succeeds, we all succeed. Give. Advocate. Volunteer. Live United. Take the pledge at unitedway.org. Brought to you by United Way, the Ad Council, and the National Football League.
You are a waste. A loser. Everyone hates you. Why don't you just stay in your car and keep driving? I'm serious. Drive until you run out of gas, then get out of your car and walk until you find someone who doesn't think you're dumber than bricks. Could take a while, but at least all that walking might burn a couple of calories.
You may not witness bullying like this every day. Your kids do. They want to help, but they don't know how. Visit stopbullying.gov to learn safe, simple ways your child can help stop bullying. Be more than a bystander at stopbullying.gov. A message from the Ad Council.
And now, back to the sports jock, Wayne Gandy.
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. I feel like I'm in a 1976, 72 Superfly movie. Jive Turkey.
Car wash. That's righteous, brother.
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. We were talking NFL action, and like I said, tonight, good game on Monday night. You better enjoy it. It hasn't been a lot of them. The Patriots going to Carolina to take on War Eagle Cam Newton. Should be a good game if the real Cam Newton shows up. Like I said, when he shows up, they play great. Yesterday, being broken down, the Jets. The Jets are just Jekyll and Hyde. you see him 1 week, it's like, oh, okay, Jets going to win the division. You see him the next week, it's like, yeah, this is the Jets I thought they would be. Buffalo 37-14. Big Ken, I know you probably didn't want to watch this. It was 20-0 for the longest.
Listen, I understand the whole Jekyll and Hyde. when I see the Jets down, it's like the Hyde is coming. You know what I'm saying? it's like when the facial hair starts to grow and the nails start to get long, you're about to get the ugly monster out of the Jets. So right. I'm not about to sit around and watch you turn into a beast and disappoint me.
Right.
If you start losing early on, I'm through with it.
And I said that because it's week to week with them.
Right.
You could tune them in this coming Sunday, and they'll beat somebody 40-15.
Convincingly.
Their biggest sign, they signed Ed Reed, who was released by the Texans earlier in the week. The 35-year-old future Hall of Famer who had signed with the Houston Texans on the offseason. I really think Ed said what he said, so they would cut him because at this point in his career, he doesn't want, the Texans aren't going to the playoffs, so why stay on a playoff team? I think that's why people thought that Tony Gonzalez might leave the Falcons, because at a certain point, if we're not going to go anywhere, and I'm saying this is my last year, but Ed even suited up and played yesterday. Ed played under head coach Rex Ryan when he was the defensive coordinator for the Ravens back early in his career. The Jets losing to Buffalo 37-14 in a game that basically took all day to play because of a rain delay. The Baltimore Ravens lost to the Chicago Bears.
Before you move on, though, did you see the video of the guy who fell out of the stadium at the Bills game?
He fell from the 300 level to the 200 level.
And fell on some dude and hurt him, too. They both had to go to the hospital.
So he didn't die. He's still alive, right?
They're both still
alive. The guy on the blessing. 200 level had a head injury. The guy from the 300 level had shoulder injury.
Is there a video of that? I think during the game they showed it. I don't know if they put it up.
Yeah,
I might have to find some video.
I sent it to the good producer.
Good producer, do you have a video of the guy falling? Okay. He must have had to go use the restroom. He came back with some toilet paper.
On his sneaker. But, yeah, I mean, it looked like the guy was kind of horsing around. He was kind of sliding down the banister and then just lost his balance and flipped over the side.
You have it. Here's the video of you on the Sports Jock page. This is a gentleman yesterday at the Jets-Buffalo game. He's falling. It's kind of hard.
There he goes.
You see, he's sliding on the pole. This is what alcohol will do to you.
Okay.
Like, what part of sliding on any of that? I mean, you do that at your house. but can I see that one more time?
Not when you're like three stories up.
And this is what I want to know. How much of this will be the liability of the Buffalo Bills security force? That's not something that you don't recognize. You know what I'm saying? This dude's up there sliding. Where's the security people that go, hey, dude,
right. And you see him. He's on the pole. It's kind of dark. He's sliding, and he falls over. Boom. I don't know if you can get the security. By the time I looked up and you were sliding, he falls, and I know the guy that he fell on is going to sue him. But if he's in the 300 section, he probably doesn't have a lot to get. So I don't know, Big Kenny, how you feel about that. But what tragedy. They're going to take the rails and put some glass walls up now. Policy is going
to
change.
It's something is about to start changing because this is the third, fourth, maybe fifth.
Just this year. Last year it was.
Exactly.
there was one at the Braves game, right?
Yes.
Right. I mean, and a couple have been.
Is that the Georgia Dome last year?
Right. So, a couple have been. Several have been fatalities.
Yeah, they're going to have like some guardrails and all that kind of stuff.
I guess the bottom line, though, is you can't. How can you protect people from their own stupidity?
You can't. Because NFL has tried to don't sell the 16-ounce beer. Well, the guy's just going to buy a 12 8-ounce beers. I mean, he's just going to keep drinking, or he's going to drink in his tailgate. So people get more drunk at the tailgate than they do in the stadium. I never really understood why they try to, you know, it's not like basketball. In football, you tailgate. I know people that get hammered at the tailgate. Mm-hmm. By the time they get to the stadium, they only need one beer.
Right.
So, and that's all. It's just to keep them being thirsty.
To keep it going.
Yeah.
Right?
And that's just economics.
Right.
Because it's cheaper to drink at the tailgate than it is inside the stadium.
But we probably will see some changes very soon in that going on in the NFL. Great game. If you missed it, Detroit, Pittsburgh, with the rumors of Ben Roethlisberger saying that he wants to leave. He denies. I really believe Ben in this instant. I don't know why he would want to leave Pittsburgh at this point in his career. The Steelers do go big over the Lions, 37-27. Hats off to the D coordinator for changing his game plan. Some kind of way he must have been drunk in the first half. He was trying to guard Megatron man-to-man. And you can't guard a guy named Megatron with just one guy.
With men, just right. he's not a man. He's a Megatron.
So. All the damage that he'd done, he did 6 catches, almost 200 yards and 2 TDs. All that was in the first half. And then the coordinator realized, oh, well, what we're going to do, we're going to use 2 or 3 people over here on Megatron. And that helped the Steelers come back. Steelers are 4-6. Lions are kind of like the Jets. Yeah, they're week to week. You don't know which Lions team is going to show up. In other action yesterday, Kansas City took their undefeated record into Denver. Frankenstein Manning, as Kenny called it. No, you changed his name.
To Peyton Stein.
Peyton Stein, Manning. Kansas City losing to Denver last night. Denver, Peyton Manning just knows how to play the position. You try to take something from him, it takes him a little while, but you're going to have to score some points. I think the Chiefs defense did the best they could do at the time, but the man just knows what he's doing in the pocket.
And he's like a true Frankenstein monster. He's got bolts in his neck. He's got a foot that's, you know, been surgically repaired or something.
Right.
They got his foot wrapped up and taped on, and this dude still goes out and produces.
He
produces. That man's got some focus.
Yes. I mean,
he can eliminate all the pain, all of the
distractions.
Yeah, and win.
And win. Kansas City wide receiver Dwayne Bowe did play. He was arrested earlier in the week, charged with speeding and possession of marijuana. But unlike Michael Vick boys, Bowe's boys said it was their stuff. We'll never know, but they said it was their marijuana. So he was allowed to play. All they could really get him for was speeding.
Right.
So I'm not saying that is right, wrong. So don't, are you advocating? No, I'm just saying it's good to see that somebody got some boys that'll stick up for him, because Michael Vick boys threw him under the bus.
Is it against the law to say, hey, take one for the team? Come on, dude. The reason you are where you are now is because of my helping to support you.
Mm-hmm.
And, it's not like we holding the speedboat full of weed.
It's just a little taste.
It's a little misdemeanor charge worth, and I'll pay for the lawyer.
Little taste in the car. At the game, Tiger Woods was spotted hanging with his beauty, Lindsey Vonn, on the sideline. Lindsey in her snow boots. She is in Denver, so she was ready.
Tiger in his snow bunny.
There you go. You see Tiger chilling at the game, looking happy. She got on her Red Bull. They wear their sponsorships now. You know, check her out now. She got on the Red Bull cap. Tiger has on his Nike. Tiger look like he smoked a little weed. Didn't he?
Tiger, look at his eyes.
His lips a little brown right there. But talking to the legendary John Elway in that photo right there. Lindsay is from Denver, correct? Is she from that area?
I don't know if she's from there, but does she train there?
I thought you dated her back.
No, it wasn't me.
Look, oh. And if you
it wasn't me.
If you see some of the other pictures, ain't another brother within 500 yards of Tiger. You know what I'm saying? He keep it pimping.
Well, you know, our producers don't find us good pictures, so I don't have those pictures you see, Kenny.
Oh,
I have okay. those little. Fire him.
Okay.
Yeah, fire him when we
hey,
end.
Hey, you're fired. let's not drag it out.
Oh, we're going to go to break. We come back. We're going to talk about your boy Trent Williams. He says the ref cursed him out during the game yesterday. Michael Vick is selling cars, and Andre Ellington had his hair pulled out. That and much more as the Sports Shock Show goes on and 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 on. Play that song, Ray. I bet you can't find it. Look how you're looking for it, though. Oh, that
he's
boy
quick.
Good. Matching Gill, I tell you.
Sack. Chicken wings? Ice cold brews? You know, Bob, he might want to hit the showers and head to Hooters.
Hooters is your one-stop shop for food, fun, and fantasy football.
Get your very own fantasy football draft kit and keep up-to-the-minute stats with Hooters' totally free Wi-Fi.
Great food, great fun, and your very own cheerleaders, the world-famous Hooters girls.
Hooters!
Visit HootersDraftParty.com to book your party.
It's not always easy being a dad.
When's the fairy princess coming?
Any minute now.
What? What do you mean she's not coming?
But it's always worth it.
It's the fairy princess!
It is I!
Grooves! Zinkle bells!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life.
I know it's really you, Drew. I'm just pretending for the other kids.
Take time to be a dad today. Call 877-4-DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
This is Nnamdi Asamoah. I play football for the Philadelphia Eagles, but what I do off the field with United Way might be more important. I'm a volunteer tutor and mentor. Why? Because over a million kids a year drop out of school, and that's not okay. It takes 12 years to create a graduate, but it takes about the same time to create a dropout. And the difference between a child becoming one or the other could be me, or it could be you. Studies show that if we get to these kids earlier, their chances are better. And kids who read well by third grade are more likely to graduate. So join me in United Way. Suit up and take the pledge. Become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor. Because when a child succeeds, we all succeed. Give. Advocate. Volunteer. Live United. Take the pledge at unitedway.org. Brought to you by United Way, the Ad Council, and the National Football League.
You are a waste, a loser. Everyone hates you. Why don't you just stay in your car and keep driving? I'm serious. Drive until you run out of gas, then get out of your car and walk until you find someone who doesn't think you're dumber than bricks. Could take a while, but at least all that walking might burn a couple of calories.
You may not witness bullying like this every day. Your kids do. They want to help, but they don't know how. Visit StopBullying.gov to learn safe, simple ways your child can help stop bullying. Be more than a bystander at StopBullying.gov. A message from the Ad Council.
So, Jacqueline.
Yes, Mom?
I wanted to talk to you about something, and... Oh, wait. Hold on. I just got a text. Oh, there's another one. Wow. Busy, busy me. So, anyway...
Oh, wait, Mom. I just got a message. My friends keep commenting on my comment. Oh, there's another one. So many comments on my comment.
Oh, I can't wait to watch TV tonight. Playoffs!
Hey, guys, check out my new video game. Pew, pew.
Wait.
Mom, what?
What?
Hold on. What'd you say? Wait a second, what?
This weekend, unplug. Take your family to the forest. There's nothing in the world like experiencing nature firsthand. Trees, paths, bluebirds, streams. Getting closer to nature can get you closer to your family. To find the forest nearest you, go to discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Hey, over here.
What?
Right here in the back.
Where?
Over by the fence.
You? The bike?
Yeah, the bike. Right in the grass where the kids left me a while ago. You know how lonely it is being left day after day, not being able to cruise the reservation?
Pardon me?
Remember when you got me for the kids? You told them, "Now you kids go have fun, enjoy the outdoors, and be careful."
Yeah?
I really miss it, especially when they put that playing card in my spokes, and I made a really cool sound the faster we went. Well, could you get my tires a little air, dust off my seat, and remind the kids how fun I still am?
Okay. Oh, you are dusty.
Yeah, and I may need a couple of bolts tightened, too. Now let's go.
As Native American parents and caregivers, our encouragement to healthy lifestyles for our kids is helping them get outside and play. Get ideas, get involved, get going at letsmove.gov/Indian Country. Brought to you by USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
And now, back to the sports jock, Wayne Gandy.
We're doing Death Row songs today. That is Guy Rawlings' Death Row song. He still wants to fight the power.
On the way out.
On the way out. The good producer is rolling with Lovely Days. I don't know who that's by.
Bill Withers.
Bill Withers. Like I said, I don't know who that's by. And Massengill is rolling with... Now That We Found Love.
By Third World.
By Third World. I'm riding with a little Biggie. And soon to come will be the funny man, Big Kenny. I can't wait to see what he comes. He'll probably have some Marvin Gaye or something.
On my way out?
On the way out. You know?
On the way out? This is my last ride, baby, and I'm going to go with Marvin?
We'll see as the show goes on. As we left, we were talking about Tiger Woods being at the game with Lindsey Vonn. Chatting it up with his Stanford alum, John Elway, on the side. Remember, John Elway got his number retired at Stanford about 2 weeks ago. Big ups to the great John Elway. Tiger Woods' niece, Big Kenny, was telling me, who is also a golfer. She has her own little tricks, as this video shows, that she can do things that Tiger can do. I don't know. Tiger's been teaching her well. She's
change hands.
Might just be bang. She hit the ball better than all of us playing with it. Balls and playing with it. That's not right.
Let's hope she's better.
That is his niece. What is her name?
Cheyenne.
So we got a Tiger and we got some Cheyenne. The Woods are just taking over. How old is she? Any of you know how old she is?
Old enough.
She did look a little thick in the thigh, guy. I can't believe you was checking that out, guy.
Me no.
Cheyenne. Wood, is her last name Woods?
Yes, Cheyenne Woods.
She's 23.
See, told you old enough.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she makes the quota.
Yeah. you can't take that to court.
You can't take it to court.
Yeah.
She can almost rent a car.
Maybe in the court of public opinion, but...
in that court is
right,
good.
You ain't about to do no time for Cheyenne Woods.
Yesterday, during the game, left tackle for the Washington Redskins, Trent Williams is claiming that one of the referees called him fat, ASS garbage, during the loss to the Eagles. He wants the NFL to do something about it. He feels that it's wrong for a referee. Grow up!
Thank you.
Grow up. I had many battles with refs. I called him names. He called me names. It's just a sport. It's competitive. It is high in intensity. Grow up. Did you really get to the locker room and tell the reporters this? You know how that sounds? Hey, the ref cursed me out, coach. Big Kenny, what part of the game are we playing now in the NFL?
Jonathan Martin has opened up the soft shoe door.
The soft batch cookies.
The soft batch door. He has opened up the door for everybody who wanted to be soft and pie-backed to come on out and say it. You know what I mean? It used to be where I would like to whine and cry, but that's not acceptable. Then you see, oh, one other guy's whining and crying. Maybe I'll do it. Everybody now starting to complain. Did you really say a referee hurt your feelings? is that what we're talking about right now? Is a referee hurt your feelings?
Can you believe this guy?
I was shocked when I read that. I was like, really? You know, he's an offensive tackle. What is it with the offensive linemen? These are your boys.
And what did he call him?
He called him.
I don't know. Can I say that word on the air?
No.
No. Fat blank. Garbage.
Yeah, fat garbage blank. Fat garbage.
Fat butt garbage.
Yes.
Another word for butt.
And then a disrespectful MF.
So
my grandmother called me all of that.
Boy, get your fat.
and this is a true story.
That's just real. Yeah.
This is a true story.
Yes.
I'm talking about, you know, on my way to my first day of preschool kind of stuff. And, you know. We getting talked to like that, and you know, I love your little fat A.
Yeah, that's my
but
name. Yeah.
You're lazy, and you know, get up and let's get on where we gotta go. And nobody cried about it, and if we did cry about it, you were very, very much ostracized in my family for being soft.
Or the person you told might punch you in the chest.
Yeah,
and
right.
Tell you to toughen up. Yeah, did you tell me that?
Did you just really come say
I told you about it,
because
you used to get beat for telling on people.
Yeah.
Right.
People don't realize that used to be a beating, too.
That's what the NFL needs to do. Let me give you something to cry about.
Oh,
that's
man.
What my parents would say. Oh, what, you crying? Let me give you something to cry about.
This is where the game is going.
In school now, they encourage kids to speak up if something's going on. When I was in school, I would go to a teacher, if I ever went to a teacher, or a student went to a teacher and said, hey, Johnny's messing with me. The teacher would look that kid in the eye and go, stop being a tattletale.
Yes.
Go sit down.
That's how it basically worked.
And now grown men are talking about, you hurt my feelings by the way you talk to me. That's embarrassing, man.
That is crazy.
That's embarrassing. They're killing the game with this.
Killing it. I'm lost. I'm like, God, like I don't. And it's my offensive line brothering. I don't get it at all. In a funny video we do have for you in the Jacksonville Arizona game, in which Arizona won, running back Andre Ellington. Had a, I don't even know if you can say uniform malfunction. Part of his uniform is his hair, though, on the football field. You can't horse collar, but you can pull the hair. That's Ellington running the ball right there, number 38. And when he gets up, he got the ball in his hand, but he's missing something. His hair, Big Kenny. There's the hair. Oh, get out of here. That's what he said. Get out of here. Let me see that one more time. Andre is running the ball. The linebacker gets in there. This is what I'm talking. This is man football. This is macho world right here. Look how he looked at it. Get your out of here.
We scalping people out here.
We are taking heads. And that is legal, just so you know. If you wear your hair outside of your helmet, they can pull it. They tell you to put it up. Now, if you want to wear it out, I don't know what to tell you. I think the guy you said he did report on Twitter that he's getting it sewn back in today.
That he had it sewn back in, which is suspect.
What part
of the game is that? Are you really? Not only are you getting extensions, but you willing to admit it? Come on, man. What part of the game? Is there nobody around these people who love them enough to hold them down and punch them in the chest?
That's bullying, man. You can't
do that in America anymore. That's called corrective action. You correcting behavior with stuff like that, man. That's what it does. It helps you to prevent embarrassing all of us.
And what's so funny in the video, he instantly knows that his hair is out. he stands up, off the ground, and he looks down looking for his, what is that, dreadlocks? What are the extensions, you said it was?
Yeah, they got to be extensions because I wore dreadlocks, and you would feel
when he gets
some
up,
pain.
He felt that hair come out. He's looking down at the ground.
And he's thinking that's Indian Remy. It costs 13. You know, that's,
you said
about
Indian Remy,
right? That's about $150 worth of hair right there on the ground. So
he is looking for his hair. Mike Vick, even though he is not on the field as of late, his Eagles did win yesterday. Excuse me, Mike Vick did not play, but he does have a website where he is selling cars. Do y'all have the video for that? Let's play that Mike Vick video for Guy and Big Kenny.
Welcome to ShowMike.com. I'm a car enthusiast and love to see what people have done with their toys. ShowMike.com is an online car show where you can upload your vehicle, motorcycle, boat, or ATV and show me what you've done. You're able to rate others' profiles and ultimately your ride can be featured on my home screen. Each week, I'll be browsing through to pick my favorite ride, which also will be featured on my home screen. Don't forget to check out my profile. You've seen me on the field, now you've seen me in my rides. I check yours out too.
Welcome to ShowMike.com. Can I see that ad at the end? Can y'all freeze it on that ad? ShowMike.com. Mike always loved cars. He's a car enthusiast. And kind of like, I guess it's kind of like Pimp My Ride, that show. Maybe an online show kind of like that where he's showing different cars of different players. He must have taken care of all his financial responsibilities and now is rocking his rides. I saw a Escalade Matt Gray in there. Looked like an Audi was to the left. What was that car?
Not
to
a Benz.
Benz to the left. And what's that in the back there?
Looks like is that a Lincoln or a Chevy?
In the maybe an F-150?
Yeah, maybe
F-150. F-150 in the back. Mike.com. So for you people that want to see what Mike Vick is riding in, Mike is in the trying to get some off, you know, after career stuff going. He got this going. He got the brush. Remember early in the year we
the
reported?
Wave
he
brush.
Got the wave brush going. Oh, yeah. So that's little right. Little things trying to be an intro. Pro, you can't say that other part.
Yeah, what, Negro?
That
can we
part.
Say Negro? Right.
Yeah, I guess you can say that is a color.
Learn your script, Mike, so you can stop reading off the cue card.
Yeah, right.
With SportMike.com.
So we'll be back for the Sports Talk Show right after this.
Sack. Chicken wings? Ice cold brews? You know, Bob, he might want to hit the showers and head to Hooters.
Hooters is your one-stop shop for food, fun, and fantasy football.
Get your very own fantasy football draft kit and keep up-to-the-minute stats with Hooters' totally free Wi-Fi.
Great food, great fun, and your very own cheerleaders, the world-famous Hooters girls.
Hooters!
Visit HootersDraftParty.com to book your party.
Can you tell if these vegetables are being contaminated with bacteria that could cause paralysis? Listen, you can't see it either. Use different cutting boards so that the bacteria in raw meats and seafood and their juices doesn't touch prep surfaces for other foods like veggies. Raw food may contain bacteria that can make you very sick or worse. Roughly 3,000 Americans will die from food poisoning this year, but you can keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov. Brought to you by the USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
And now, back to the sports jock, Wayne Gandy.
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. I'm the Sports Jock, Wayne Gandy. College football was... Well, I didn't see much of it. I was at the Auburn game. War Eagle. So play that. Show that play to Big Kenny and Guy again. They want to see it one more time. Yeah, play that play right there.
Yeah, we just don't know how we'll go through the day without seeing this for the 115th time this morning.
Spoiler alert, he catches the ball.
Haters, man.
lets it go.
Touchdown, Auburn! The Auburn Tigers on a miracle play at the end, defeating the Georgia Bulldogs. A great game, and a game that I know the Georgia fans did come back, but Auburn really, really dominated this game. They were up 20 points going into the fourth, and they just let Georgia keep slowly creeping back in. But what a play. I mean, that's just a play that just happens here and there, kind of Hail Mary-ish. One player trying to – you're really supposed to knock the ball down. If any of you kids want to know, in that situation, you're not actually supposed to try to intercept it. You're supposed to knock the ball down. That's what happens when you try
when
to intercept it.
When you're doing too much.
Instead of knocking it down. You knock it down, it's fourth down. You get the ball down there. Where else would you want to be but on the other side of the field?
He was going for the glory.
He was trying to get the glory.
And doing too much. But that was one of those wins and one of those plays that – 9 months from now, a baby will be born based on that play.
Yes, and get the name of that guy, Ricardo Lewis. Somebody's going to name their baby Ricardo Big Play Lewis or something like that. But those are the Georgia coaches during the play. We never saw that part. When he caught the ball, they all jumped on the ground. No! Look how they're all bent over. They are. Look at them, big kitty.
It's like he cut a switch off inside all of them.
A piece of them just died right there.
This is priceless, man. This is what it's all about. If you're watching this, this is where all the cursing and the intensity and things like that are in sports, because people are in it. Think about if something happens to the point that you just belly flopped. Usually something like that is you hearing somebody died. Maybe somebody's come home and tell you your wife or your loved one, your mother. You might fall on the ground like that. For some, you would never think in an athletic play, it would have the point where these guys are in the fetal position. Look at these two guys at the bottom right here.
Right. The whole staff.
Can we freeze? Is it possible to freeze that? You got to get it with it right here on the end. The whole staff. We're not talking about one guy. We're talking about four or five guys. There's a guy way down at the end. That's probably Mark Richt. Way down at the end, the head coach. I mean, they are stunned. They cannot believe what they just saw.
What was the atmosphere like in the stadium when you were there?
Half the people was kind of walking up the stairs. It's 4th and 18. And this is over. I had got up. I was back there by the nacho cart looking at the TV thinking, oh, man, we're about to lose. I need to beat the traffic. And next thing I know, the ball pops up. This is not practice. That's what I'm trying to tell you. The Georgia defender, actually, you knock the ball down. You can teach your 8-year-old son today. In this situation, you do not try to intercept the ball. Because if you play when we play it again, you'll see the guy, he tries to go and intercept. His hand hits the ball, and the guy catches it, and it's just one of those storybook plays. It's going to go up there with Cordell throwing that Hail Mary in that Michigan game, like you said, Doug Flutie. It's in that kind of, when you thought it was over, he tried to intercept the ball. Instead of knocking it down, it went up. Touchdown, Auburn.
And then, to show you what
and
it's
Ricardo
like,
Lewis got all the ladies that night. He macked. He might still be macking right now.
Yeah, he's still
I'm
trying
surprised
to get to
that
one
Valentina
of the ladies.
Is here
right.
This morning.
Right.
Surprised that she made it because he's macking everybody.
He probably got to her early, though. Yeah. You know what I mean? She caught him coming off the field. Now, the guy, what's really disappointing about what Georgia did was there were two players from Georgia that had access to the ball.
Mm-hmm.
One of them looked like maybe he was going to knock the ball down. The other one was trying to actually intercept. So you're going to knock your teammate down, hoping to get a little glory for yourself.
Correct.
Hope to make a highlight film. And
yes.
Now, instead, you are the
butt
fool,
of the joke.
Right. That cost us the game.
Cost us the game, Auburn. And for my Auburn fans, and I'm not jinxing, I'm knock on wood, don't be surprised. Auburn wins out. National title. They're 6 now. Alabama's 1. You beat Alabama. 6-1. You got to jump somebody. And then if you make it to the SEC championship game, you're probably going to be playing Missouri, who's ranked 7, 8. don't think it's out of the realm of jumping some of these teams like Baylor or Ohio State. But one game at a time, 2 weeks from now, Auburn, Alabama will be visiting the Iron Bowl. The winner goes to the SEC championship game. At Iowa State, D lineman David Irving was arrested and charged with assaulting his girlfriend, who's also the mother of his child. That's not uncommon in today's society. What is uncommon is that Irving held her down, cut off a large portion of her hair, and punched her in the leg repeatedly. What part of the game is that? Does anybody know what is leg punching? Yep, I don't know that technique.
That is unusual. What made him think, okay, you know what? This will teach you. I told you that I like the strawberry Pop-Tarts. Punch you in the leg.
Like,
I don't get it.
Like they won't bruise and have evidence for court. I don't understand. And this is what's amazing about a lot of these stupid dudes. There seems to be no thought put into this. You just out there experimenting.
He cut her hair and then punched her repeatedly in the leg. And like you said, she went down and showed him the big bruises on her legs. I didn't get it. Maybe he just didn't want to hit her in the face. I don't know. But he did get arrested. I'm quite sure he will get suspended off of the team. The CIAA championship game was canceled after a fight on Friday involving the Virginia State player, the quarterback, Rudy Johnson of Winston-Salem State. Was cornered in the restroom by some Virginia State players, and they jumped him and beat him up. He had to go to the hospital. Reports are it was five Virginia State players that did this. Both teams were 9-1. The CIAA board canceled the game after this, which deservingly so. I think maybe, to me, Virginia State should have forfeit the game. I think Winston-Salem State, I think that is, what are you, Big Kenny, punishment?
First of all, why are you in the bathroom with five players from the
They had a luncheon.
You know, when you
have those bowls.
It's at a luncheon. This dude gets into a verbal altercation in the bathroom with a bunch of these other guys. Now, hey, man, if none of your teammates are there, maybe you ought to suck this one up and then come back later, or maybe you ought to be the bigger man and walk away.
Oh, you want him to charge it to the game?
No, I'm saying you kind of bought some of that on yourself. Now, me and you are out hanging out, and it's some dudes that are Saints fans. They don't like us, and now I'm the sole Falcon fan in the bathroom, and the dude go, Falcons suck, and I'm going to look around and see 10 Saints fans and go, oh, what you want to do about it?
Fans, maybe. Other team players, you don't think that at a banquet you're going to corner me in the bathroom and beat me. I'm the starting quarterback.
This Winston-Salem and Virginia State. Come on now. You know
you said
what
I'm thinking. I'm thinking,
you know,
Auburn,
what you're
Alabama.
With. Right. You,
this ain't that. It's not that going on.
No, this ain't Georgia Tech Wesleyan. You know what time it is with these guys. That's the established reality.
Well, they canceled the game. They haven't come out with how they're going to handle it. I think that Winston-Salem State should win by default. I think that would set precedent. What do you think, guy?
I think you are correct, but it's just so stupid.
This is the craziest thing I ever heard.
Yeah, you know, because you go to these banquets and everybody's usually on their best behavior. They usually got their little khaki pants on and a little tie that fits school colors and stuff. The blue blazer, and the coaches are there, and some of the boosters are there getting ready for the game. You know, all dressed up. And you know, it's the wrong venue to do that kind of thing.
But when you bout that life, if you bout that life, turn down for what? Just because it's a banquet, turn down for what? We bout that life. That's what I'm saying. This whole culture is asleep. They are just ridiculously not thinking, man. Yeah, that is the most embarrassing.
That might be the word, sleep. They are just sleepwalking mm-hmm. around. They have cornered this man in the restroom, and the game was suspended to the point that he had to go to the hospital. So this wasn't just I shoved him into the stall.
That's what I'm saying.
I put them two pieces on him.
It's a banquet. Do you not think that this issue is going to get into the hands right. of the law?
And if it's five guys, they all had to have a turn, just like we made Massengill eat the donut. If one of us throw a punch, everybody got to throw a punch or at least get a kick in. Right. So
all in this together.
We're all in this together. So
and they ought to all be in prison together.
Yeah, that is true. That's why I said they should forfeit the game, and Winston-Salem State should win. Also, former South Carolina tailback Kenny Miles, he is charged with filing a false police report. He said somebody shot him doing a robbery. The police have found out that he shot himself. There was no robbery. y'all feel like we should just cancel the rest of the show. It's going like that today. Wow. I told you, what part of the game are these kids playing? We'll be right back. 888-926-7562. He told him he had got robbed.
Wayne Gainey's commentary is up in the next hour. It's the ocean segment. Who will go in the ocean? Who will stay out of the ocean today? Keep listening to find out on the sportsjoc.com.
Heck of a sack.
Chicken wings? Ice cold brews? You know, Bob, he might want to hit the showers and head to Hooters.
Hooters is your one-stop shop for food, fun, and fantasy football.
Get your very own fantasy football draft kit and keep up-to-the-minute stats with Hooters' totally free Wi-Fi.
Great food, great fun, and your very own cheerleaders, the world-famous Hooters girls.
Hooters! Visit HootersDraftParty.com to book your party.
This is Nnamdi Asamoah. I play football for the Philadelphia Eagles, but what I do off the field with United Way might be more important. I'm a volunteer tutor and mentor. Why? Because over a million kids a year drop out of school, and that's not okay. It takes 12 years to create a graduate, but it takes about the same time to create a dropout. And the difference between a child becoming one or the other could be me, or it could be you. Studies show that if we get to these kids earlier, their chances are better. And kids who read well by third grade are more likely to graduate. So join me in United Way. Suit up and take the pledge. Become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor. Because when a child succeeds, we all succeed. Give. Advocate. Volunteer. Live United. Take the pledge at unitedway.org. Brought to you by United Way, the Ad Council, and the National Football League.
Hey, over here.
What?
Right here in the back.
Where?
Over by the fence.
You? The bike?
Yeah, the bike. Right in the grass where the kids left me a while ago. You know how lonely it is being left day after day, not being able to cruise the reservation?
Pardon me?
Remember when you got me for the kids? You told them,
"Now you kids go have fun, enjoy the outdoors, and be careful."
Yeah?
I really miss it, especially when they put that playing card in my spokes and I made a really cool sound the faster we went. Well, could you get my tires a little air, dust off my seat, and remind the kids how fun I still am?
Okay. Oh, you are dusty.
Yeah, and I may need a couple of bolts tightened, too. Now let's go.
As Native American parents and caregivers, our encouragement to healthy lifestyles for our kids is helping them get outside and play. Get ideas, get involved, get going at letsmove.gov/Indian Country. Brought to you by USDA, HHS, and the Ad Council.
Enough is enough!
Serious.
And we hold the world ransom for
Wayne Gandy.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Show me.
Broadcasting live from the Armada FM studios in Atlanta, Georgia. This is the Sports Chalk Show with Wayne Gandy.
You have been given full access to the Players Lounge on the Sports Chalk Show with Wayne Gandy.
Welcome back to the Sports Jock Show. I am the Sports Jock, Wayne Gandy. For my Chinese Americans, just real quickly, as you know, the Sports Jock like to keep keep it going on all planes. You can have a second child now in China. They have lifted their exemption. It used to be one child per family. I wish they had that in Haines City, Florida, but they don't. But now, if you're an only child or your wife is an only child, you can have a second child now.
And as a result, women are showing up late all over China for work. You know what I'm saying? With their hair all tore up.
Everybody was late today.
Where were you, Ming Lee? Oh, my husband. He tried making other baby right now.
Just wanted to pass that along to you. And the reward for information in the slaying of Eastern Michigan's Demarius Reed has been increased to $15,000. Demarius Reed was fatally shot back on October the 18th in an off-campus apartment at Eastern Michigan. They have increased that to $15,000. So anybody that's listening that might know, snitching is in now.
Snitching for profit. Just put aside the fact that a man lost his life senselessly.
Yes.
Snitches gets riches.
I suppose. I mean, you know, as a good citizen, you would want that type of crime to be curbed and punished. But I'm not going to say nothing, but, $15,000.
Right. Let's quickly, before we introduce our guests, we got an Auburn Tiger in the building. I told you it was all thing Auburn today. Got some birthdays real quickly. Since we're talking about snitching, just let me know, snitch or not a snitch on these birthdays. Russell Westbrook. Stumped you. You don't know?
Questionable fashion. he need to tell on his stylist, so no, he ain't turned that dude in yet, so not a snitch.
Prince Charles.
Definitely not a snitch.
Condoleezza Rice, 59. Prince Charles, 65. Russell Westbrook, 25. Condoleezza Rice, 59.
She's not a snitch.
She's not a snitch. No. Reverend Ron, 49.
No, definitely no snitch.
Hey. Lisa Bonet, 46. You date her back in the day?
I wanted to.
Okay.
Not a snitch.
Not a snitch. O.C. Umanyora, 32. Snitch, no snitch.
No.
Reggie Wayne, 35. Can't find a snitch in none of these now. I got to find somebody that's a snitch. Delroy Lindo, 61.
Definitely not a snitch.
Martin Scorsese, 71.
No. You think he would snitch on somebody? This guy. You think he would snitch?
Let's see if I can find a. RuPaul, 53.
Yes.
I found one. A snitch. Sammy Sosa, 45.
Yep. He a tail.
He's a snitch on his skin lotion, whatever he's putting on his face to lighten
his
skin.
Have you seen this dude? This dude look like the Joker.
He looks crazy.
Fabulous, 36, the rapper Fabulous. No snitch. Owen Wilson.
No snitch.
Hall Pass ain't snitching?
No.
Okay. Amari Stoudemire, 31 years old.
Never known Amari. Snitch.
Travis Barker, 38. Snitch? No snitch.
No.
Travis almost died in an airplane crash, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he ain't snitching no more. Metal World Peace.
No.
34.
No. Nobody would believe him.
He'll snitch on himself.
Nobody would, man. You know that dude ain't right in the head.
Whoopi Goldberg, 58.
No.
Maybe. You know, talk show host.
She talk a little bit.
Yeah.
She might be a little too vocal. I don't know if she a snitch.
Dwight Gooden, 49.
Nah. He got too much in his closet.
He can't on anybody.
The dude can't afford to talk.
Mike Epps, 43.
No. Not a snitch.
Not a snitch either. Sam Cassell, 44. Remember Sam Cassell?
He of the big cojones?
Yeah, that's Sam.
So he's not a snitch.
Yanni. 59.
I'm sure he's told on somebody. Just with a name like Yanni. Isn't he like the master of the pan flute or something like that?
That's him.
Yeah, any dude that's the master of the pan flute is got to be a snitch.
Danny DeVito, 69.
No,
no
snitch. No snitch for him either. Kurt Schilling, 47. He can't afford to snitch. He lost all his money. Somebody snitched on him, didn't he? Stole all his money?
I think so. Are they talking about when he had the bloody sock when he was pitching in the World Series? Yes. They said it was ink. It was like a Sharpie on his sock. So, yeah, somebody snitched on him.
Warren Moon, 57.
Nah, yeah. Warren's a bad dude. Yeah.
No snitching on. I can't. So we only have one snitch right now. Well, two. Yanni and RuPaul. David Ortiz, Big Poppy, 38.
Nah, he not telling on
Big
nobody.
Poppy don't tell on nobody. He just changed his language. Remember, I don't understand English.
And now this is our city.
Those are the birthdays of this week. We couldn't only find two snitches.
That's a good thing.
That's a good thing. Should have said some names like Chris Brown and stuff like that, snitches. It's some people, the young generation, easy. They will snitch on us. But we are here.
And then call it keeping it real.
When it's going wrong. We're in the Players Lounge, and I have an Auburn Tiger in the building, one of my former teammates. He's still looking cut up like he just got a set in over there. look at the triceps poking out the shirt.
I can't look that hard. You know what I'm saying? Just stare at his triceps.
The intern behind him looking. But I still got mine over here. Now, hold on. Now, don't.
You see a G-man.
Don't.
It's an Auburn thing. It's an Auburn thing.
You know, I can give you 25. I can't give you 26, but I can give you 25 push-up. Say what now?
I said, we'll start where you are.
Arm wrestle? That's not a manly event.
No.
This dude said, let's arm wrestle.
No, that's going to be a big old negative.
let's take turns beating the guy who suggested that.
He said arm wrestle.
Do they do that anymore?
I haven't seen an arm wrestling match in forever.
No, ever since the 70s show with Family Son.
And if you did it, you probably have to wear gloves or something because people would want to...
Exchange
the AIDS and stuff. They don't want to be sweaty. But my man Kelsey Crook is in the house. Kelsey, good morning to you.
Great morning to you, Wayne.
Thank you for coming out.
Thank you for inviting me out.
Vic Kenny, Guy is leaving us, so say bye to Guy.
Bye, Guy.
With a name like Crook, you probably hope ain't nobody snitching up in here. Glad we didn't have a whole bunch of snitches on the list this morning.
I ain't heard Joe like that since like the third grade. That was a big thing with being Crook.
Yeah.
So Crook or Kelsey, which one got you the most?
Crook as a young kid, Kelsey when I was in middle school, it was like not the most masculine name, but it was no other guy's name Kelsey. Now everybody named their little girl Kelsey.
Okay.
But I learned to wear it well, and I'm still Kelsey Crook, trained as Kelsey Supreme. So we are just revamping it. We upgrade ourselves.
You should not let a comedian hear you call yourself Supreme. Kelsey Supreme sounds like a thong and some wine.
It can go any way you want it to go.
Your next booty on duty is Kelsey Supreme.
Chick might like it. The chick.
Let me ask you: You ever use the crook thing with the ladies? I'm a crook. I'll steal your heart. Something like that. You ever try and swag it out like that?
I never tried to swag it out. I've had something to say it before. No, do that? But no, I'm not a man of lying, sir. I'm not a man of lying.
All right.
Well, Kelsey, the play the other day, Auburn beating Georgia.
Yes, sir.
How excited were you?
Overjoyed. Georgia's always a great competitor and a great rival game with Auburn. To see Georgia come back and to make it a game was exciting, but I had a feeling Auburn would pull it out there in the end. So to see that catch at that point in time, I didn't think they would score on a play like that.
Right.
So it's a miracle play in Auburn. So it's great to be an Auburn Tiger.
They want to hear you say War Eagle. Can I get a big
yes, you sure can. So I was hoping to come in here and start one off with you. War Eagle. Hey!
Yes,
now that sounds good.
That sounds real good, Big Kenny. I'm sorry y'all don't have nothing like that at Southern Miss.
Hey, man, look, we not even – Southern Miss is not even relevant in this conversation. For me to bring that up is for me to just be stalling for time. You know what I mean?
Vic Kenny went to Southern Miss. Went to Florida.
Florida.
He was down there when they were paying. Yeah,
I was down there when Brett Favre was down there, and they were actually a real football team.
So okay.
Yeah, that's when he was there. He's an Emmitt Smith guy, so
all right,
that's his era.
Y'all been around legends then?
Been around.
Yeah. Still around a legend. Got an Auburn legend now, so.
No, I'm just an old man now. But we're going to go to break. We come back. We're going to talk about your new venture. You're starting a gym.
Yes, sir.
Ask you about this obesity problem we have with children.
All right, I'd be glad to talk about it.
Is it really McDonald's fault, or is it somebody? Don't answer now. Just hold on. We'll get to that in just a second. Kelsey Crook, War Eagle, as he lets you know. 888-926-7562. We have the John Wall video ready for the guest. Is that what you want to play him? Okay. The Ooh Killer? And y'all just made that executive. Oh, he wants an action to. They don't consult me on anything on my own show. We'll be right back with more of the Sports Jock Show right after this.
888-926-7562. It's the sportsjoc.com.